Everything, everything, everything gonna be all right this morning.
Yes, I
am. Oh, yeah. Greatest man alive. But now I'm a man, way past 21. I want you to believe me, baby. I have lots of fun. I'm a man. I spell him H-I.
The views, comments, and opinions of the following program do not necessarily reflect those of Morris Media Studios, morrismedialive.com, or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
That's funny. Oh, we had the headphones. That's funny. That's funny. Oh, man. Thank you. That's funny. Oh, we're on? Okay. Oh, this is a two-shot thing.
Marcus did not call that
one. No, I don't think he knew how to call any shots. I mean, I don't think... And think about it, he wasn't even like really, you know, it's your first time directing, you focused. You know, he's down there talking to people like this is his fourth year, a tenth year doing it. You know, it was just, he was just raggedy.
Who was his AD?
I don't even know if he had one. Are we on? Oh, all right. This guy's back.
You're not saying
and
his
it was so funny. All right, it is a funny thing.
We still won't say his name.
All right, here's a funny thing. So, I pull up and he's in his car and I'm parking. So, I had to go to the restroom. So I jumped out and ran to the restroom and then he walks in. So I say as I'm walking by, "What's up, Jeff?" Real quick. That's what you do. What's up? You know, you don't really want to apply.
Yeah, it's really.
What's up, Jeff? You know, no. So. Because that was like the first time we spoke. What's up, Jeff? And then I go in, and I normally never go in and say hi to Poetess, but I didn't want to be stuck in the room. So I went in, and she's like, "What's wrong with you?" And,
Jeff is here.
And I said, and I had some vines. She said, "Give me some vines." So, and I don't even know why I went to the store and bought these. I was just going to, so I said, "Hey, what's up? Because Dan is not going to be here. So I was using that as a thing, like, "Ah, man," because Speedy called, he wanted to come. So, And then you said what? What did you say?
You couldn't make eye contact.
Yeah, yeah. He said, I was
scared. Couldn't look me in the eye. Couldn't look me in the face.
Poor right. Then I'm like, it's hard to look you in the eye because your eyes going both ways. But I didn't want to say that right away. I didn't want to start off hitting him. So, but it's good to see you.
Always good to see you.
Good to see you. I know it's up the green pants. That's new.
They old. Just going through my closet, throwing stuff out.
Oh, all right.
I hadn't worn.
Oh, you were cleaning house.
Yeah.
You know. What happened to my picture? Is it my picture still up?
Yeah, of course. Oh. Why would I take it down?
Okay.
Friendship is still.
Lou asked about you. Lou said, "Where's Uncle Jeff?" He's my son. Calls him Uncle Jeff, and I was like, "He's somewhere."
I just pull away when your ego is up there.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah.
I felt bad.
No, you shouldn't. But
I felt bad. I missed you too,
but I know when to pull away because I know when your ego is up there. And I was just like, I'm at a point now where I don't have to deal with the ego. I like dealing with you, but I don't deal with the ego. Like, the ego.
Like Philadelphia.
No, his ego.
Yeah, he's like,
you know, because all cylinders was working for you starting the new year off. You working. You saving money, you back with Code 3, you getting some pussy, so can't nobody tell you nothing.
Well, if anybody can tell me something, it's you.
No.
That's the thing. If anybody can tell me something, it's you. You're right about very few people can tell. My muse, you, and...
And then I was hearing things.
A few other people.
And then I was like, oh, okay. So then I
You were hearing things.
No, I mean, you know, on the show, I watched the show, and I was just like, oh, okay. You know, you tried to emasculate me and all that. And I was like, that's cool.
I drove by your crib a few times, but I didn't stop.
Like, that's cool. But then I was like, you know what? The roller coaster's up there. It's coming down. So this is what I did. Because the love I have for you.
What?
I bought $200 because I know you're going to need it soon.
Now that is true.
I know you're going to need it soon.
That is true. It does go in cycles.
It's there for you when you need it.
That does go in cycles. And I felt that. Because I even said it on the show. I said I had a friend and, you know, Speedy came. But it did hurt my feelings. Not that I get my feelings hurt much. When you did, because I listened to that part of the show when you said we're not going to say his name.
It was intentional.
I felt that pierced me.
Yeah,
I was like, wow, really?
Yeah.
And I'm like, I always say his name.
Yeah, but I didn't want to come on here. I just wanted to go a different route because I was like, you know what? I'm not going to do the negative thing about him. I'm not going to say nothing bad about him because, I'm not going to be that person. So I just said, you know what? We're going to start off. We're not going to say his name.
And that's when I was like, all right, you done. I was like, all right, you done. I mean, I've never fired anybody. I knew I couldn't fire you anyway, but and, I mean, how are you going to get fired from something that's not getting paid for,
right. So. But then also on the opposite hand, I was like, oh, okay, now he's showing his ass. Now the gatekeeper in him came out now. The gatekeeper now. Now he's claiming it's his show.
And the instigator, the low-key instigator here, was nothing low-key about him.
No, that's my dog.
I kept calling him for advice.
He was like...
I kept calling him for advice, like, yo, man, what do you think? You know, what do you think? And then he was breaking it down to me.
Yeah, you're gay.
and Dannon felt good because he was shiny.
Jeez.
So he felt good because he think he a star. Ooh. So, you know, that was him and the cat. I kept calling, what's up? I kept calling TDP, said, yo, man, what do you think? What do you think? What do you think? And then you're right. Then I was like, all right, you ain't gonna say my name. Then you gotta.
That's when the gatekeeper came out of you.
It's Beyonce, like, say
yeah,
my name.
Yeah, yeah. Like, you know, he came with it like, oh, you can't do my show with my name in the title. I was like, what? Okay.
And I asked TDP. I said, well, you think he listening? Nah, he's like, I said he ain't listening.
I said you
listening. He said, all right. Well, I'm glad you're back.
All right.
It feels better without Dannon here. He thinks he's a star.
He can't call in?
I don't know. He
can't Skype him?
I don't know what he's doing. You can send him a text to find out. People like him, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, we wore him out yet last week.
No, y'all wore Speedy out last week.
Yeah, where's Speedy at?
He called to see if he could. He said, you need me. That's what he said.
No.
You need me this week? I was like, what?
I need you.
And I was like, nah, unfortunately, Jeff's coming back.
Yeah, exactly.
I said, Jeff's coming back. But then Dannon, it says, oh, I can't make it. And Poet is like, Boss Lady was like, well, you should have just had Speedy come. But I was like, he ain't going to fit up here.
Mm. Did you watch the show when
Literally.
When y'all started on his mom when she passed?
I didn't.
Did you see Lewis. The look on his face?
Yeah.
Oh man.
Oh, when we talked about his. Miss Caldwell.
He said look? Nobody's ever asked him that question. Yeah. So.
And then the look on his face, and then you just went in.
Well, yeah, I mean, what are we supposed? I mean, he went in on Dannon though when you said.
No, let's stick keep
to,
a parent.
Yeah, let's stick to that. It's what? Like, yo, the look on his face.
On Speedy's you, face? Yeah. What do you expect us to do?
I told you he was watching.
We clowned him at his son's funeral.
I know.
We did jokes about
and
it.
I was mad. I was like, damn, I didn't get to add my two cents to it. Like, his mom couldn't oversleep.
His mom. She couldn't oversleep.
It's like she wasn't going to be late for nothing.
Like you said, rest in power. Donald III.
Yeah, Donald III was, yeah, it was good.
So,
yeah.
At the funeral, Speedy had his shirt on. So I'm like, why would you wear that shirt? That's horrible. So we was all in the parking lot, and he came out. I said, why are you wearing that shirt? It looks horrible on you. He said, it's my son's favorite shirt. I said, yeah, his favorite shirt.
Yeah, because we were in back clowning his
speech. He came back there and sat with us.
Speech, huh?
He came back there and sat with
us. Remember the two people who were in the front?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Didn't really like the fact that we were telling jokes.
Yeah.
It was inappropriate. It was like, right. Come on.
Yeah, for you.
Yeah, for them. We had fun, you know.
Speedy, you're bombing.
That's nothing funnier than comedians' funerals.
This is the biggest crowd you ever have all week. You're bombing.
Oh. All right, I'm Lewis Dix.
TDP.
I'm Geoff Arnold.
All right, how was, we're
excuse
back.
Excuse me, in a man's world. Yeah, tighten up your belt.
Exactly. I asked
huh? Her, girl, you know I
found a new song. Muddy Waters. Mannish. You ever heard it?
Okay, yeah. It's in my playlist.
It's a great song.
Mm-hmm.
But
no, you know it's a great song?
What?
Lamont Dozier. Fish Ain't Biting.
Really?
He has music.
I found, well, he always says I don't know how to pick songs.
You don't.
I'm a one-hit wonder guy.
Yeah. Beanie Siegel is, so he represents Philly.
Philly.
So, all right, I heard something about the Meek Mill thing.
What you hear?
Yeah.
Something about on the internet, and he said, that's going to be in your report?
What? You're not a real rapper.
Everybody's talking about him and, Dannon who? Would know all this stuff. Him and Puffy and.
Oh, yeah, and I remember
saying
that.
That D was good or something. Mm-hmm. What is going on with men?
It's been a horrible.
That's them Philly boys.
It's been a horrible Black History Month.
That's them Philly boys.
Good point. it has been a bad Black. Day. That's a good point.
It's been it a has horrible been, yes. Black History Month.
For Philly.
Yeah. No, just for people
for
in general.
No, for Philly. Your boy told on Wayne Martin and Will Smith.
Yeah,
your Philly boy. Yeah, Philly.
And you know it's really starting to
take
come
this
out
L.
With all of that? You know who's the worst of them all?
Who?
But nobody's talking about it?
Who?
Bobby Womack.
Ooh.
Well, but what he did.
Yes.
With Sam Cooke.
Yes.
Yeah, I've read that. What did he do?
He's fucking his wife.
Okay.
Then he wore one of his suits and drove his car to the funeral.
What's wrong with that?
then he got through with the wife and started fucking the daughter and married the daughter.
I'll say this to Poetess because we did have Bobby Womack as a guest on Reach Around Radio, RAR.
Oh, really?
Okay. And he told us about the Gilliam flip.
Oh.
He got burnt in New York with a white girl. Mm. And he had to go to the clinic that was performing that night.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, see.
Bobby Womack. Absolutely.
You mean she gave him?
The Gilliam flip.
What's the Gilliam flip? VD?
Why are you alive?
You never had it.
What?
The Gilliam flip.
Why?
No, what is that?
It's a venereal disease.
Okay. Okay.
No. Him and his backup singers got it from the girl right there. Nobody was saying they was fucking her. But now we all going to the doctor together.
Right.
Okay. Now we know we was all fucking it.
Wow.
Yeah. Bobby Womack.
Called the Gilliam
Rest
Flip.
Rest in power. Gilliam Flip. In New York.
Wow. Is that a Black history fact?
Yes, it is.
The interview was so wild.
Hmm.
His keepers were like, no, they got upset.
Yeah.
But he was having a good old time talking about how
I
he
asked
got
Bobby
beat.
Womack. I said, did you ever put Al Green's ass? No, he wasn't around then.
So if you guys want to hear that full interview, it's
please.
Out there on the internet on Reach Around Radio.
Could you put it on our Facebook page?
I will.
Yeah, I would like to listen to that.
Yeah, it is so good. It was so fun.
He said, y'all family.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, his people's.
He was like, no, Bobby, no.
Yeah, his peoples was like, what are they doing? He ain't never been in an interview like that before.
Because when I read that shit about him, I was like, damn, that's some cold blood.
Yeah, we didn't ask him about that, but we knew about it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Can I do that?
Do what?
At your funeral? Why I couldn't fit one of your suits?
Wait, can I mention one more past guest?
Okay, sure.
Les Brown. Remember that?
Motherfucking Les Brown.
I think I was there for that interview.
You wanted to be.
Okay.
Yeah.
To Gladys Knight, right?
Yeah, the motivational speaker. Was doing some recording at the studio we were at. So he heard us. He heard the show one day, and he asked us. He said, "I want to come on to your show
and change your lives."
And I said, "Nah, I don't think that's a good idea." I said, "Cause we're pretty wild. We cuss and do all that." He goes, "Nah, I want to be on your show." He was persistent about it.
Change your lives.
So he gets on the show, and he starts with this: "You guys are so intelligent. Why do you curse so much?" Mm-hmm. And then Speedy and TDP started going off.
But wait a minute. He was with that lady, that female lawyer.
Uh-huh.
I can't remember her name.
Uh-huh.
But she was like, "Oh, yeah, they winning." And then Nat Turner called and said, "Man, shut your motherfucking ass up. Don't want to hear that bullshit." I said, "Well, that's 8-0 for us, Les."
Oh, y'all wore him out like that?
He got wore out. Like, they was going, "Motherfucking Les Brown in the house." Like,
give it up for Les motherfucking Brown.
Yeah.
Now, was he laughing?
He was battling and losing at the same time.
So he was trying to convince y'all not to do that.
Right.
That's the wrong thing to do.
But we took a
vote. We were like, you got shows like Steve Harvey and all these other clean comics. This is what we do.
Right.
But this is what ingratiated him to our show. Because when I first walked in and I seen him, I said, "Les Brown, oh shit." Because on the way to Reach Around Radio, mm-hmm. I would listen to him on the AM station. He had Mama May May's son, you know. Mm-hmm. So I used to listen to Les Brown. So I introduced myself before the show, but then I gave it to him during the show.
So the next day I called him because he was so defeated after he left the show.
Yeah.
I was like, "Let me call him just to make sure he's cool." And I called him and Reach Around Radio tore him up. He was like, I never experienced that before.
I'm a motivational speaker.
So upset. Y'all motivated him out.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we got him.
Can we get him back?
He might.
Yeah.
Well, we're not as wild as Reach Around Radio.
But here was the turning point, because Speedy didn't know who he was. So when we brought up the fact that he was married to Gladys Knight, we like, "Oh, that's you?"
Hilarious.
The show's already over, sir.
Well, good for him.
Absolutely.
So, how was your week?
I'm alive.
How was your week?
Your
3 weeks? Or how long have you been gone?
I wasn't counting.
Yeah.
But I made it through another trash week. So
that,
I'm good.
That part.
Okay.
I got to take out my trash last night. So
beautiful.
I took out Coach 3's trash yesterday.
You supposed to?
Yeah, supposed to.
Did you take the gun with you?
No, she hid the gun. She's on a cruise.
That's a bad neighborhood.
So are you allowed to stay at the house while she go?
Yeah.
Oh, no, you
I
ain't.
Got a key.
Oh,
but she's got a ring bell, so she know when I'm going in.
Let's order pizza.
Oh, wow.
Huh? Let's order pizza and watch a movie.
Put our feet up, wear our shoes and
I mean, are we friends or not?
Yeah. Now, she hid the piece.
She got the ring camera, so she know when you in and out.
Yeah, so she know even the side doors.
Even when the company coming over.
Motion detector.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
So normally what I do is when I go over, I ring the bell and just wave. But she says it goes off, just motion.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, you know now.
Did
she give you the code so you can delete the camera?
Of course not.
There's a code where you can delete the
camera? Yes.
Well, you don't have it.
Yeah, we can review the camera, all of that.
Yeah, rewind it.
So she on a cruise now, and she's sitting in her room on her phone watching you when you come in. So you know exactly the time you get this. So you can't even lie no more.
Well, no, I'm normally basic time.
Why your voice
practice.
So high? Jeez.
So we are CIF Open Division Champions.
I heard.
Yeah. Did I send you a picture?
Don't show it.
Yeah. Is it a video? I thought it was a picture.
Yeah, you won. No, you was that excited. Roosevelt took him down.
But I mean, we were winning the whole time. They felt that they were cheated. But the refs are having bad calls all game, man.
How many did y'all win by?
We won by six.
That's a win.
Six or eight.
Two threes in the layup.
But what happened was our guy who's going to USC missed four free throws.
That's about
end of
right.
the game. They fouled him. He missed them. And then on this last miss, they called a foul on one of their best players to say that he grabbed one of our guys.
Yeah.
On the video, everyone says he didn't foul him. Okay. And then he made the two free throws. Mm. Okay. And
no, I don't.
It's not a video, is it? Because I got a really big team, and they need some really big rings. They need some really nice things. Better be coming with no strings. Better be coming with no strings. We need some really nice things. We need some really big rings. I got a really big.
Why you put it to Drake?
Yeah.
Why you got it on, I didn't do that.
Why you got it on WhatsApp?
Yeah.
I didn't do that. That's what I saw it, and I was like, oh, let me show y'all. Because you saw the picture of me.
I didn't see
that. So you don't wear your gym shoes.
Oh, yeah, I had on dunks.
Okay.
I had on dunks. This is the first year we're allowed to wear sneakers. Before, we had to wear dress shoes.
Yeah, you had them hard but bottoms.
But another coach came, Ed from Sierra Canyon, and he wasn't wearing shoes. Mm-hmm. So they said, all right, we got to go with sneaks.
That's right.
So everyone wears.
Is Ed black?
Is
Ed black?
Yeah, it's black.
Okay, cool.
Because
we know you weren't going to push that agenda.
Nah. I like it the way it was.
No, everybody's happy about it because they like wearing it. These guys are sneakerhead. Now, that's the thing. I didn't realize that guys have 50 to 75 to 100 pair of sneakers.
At the minimum.
I'm like, you know, I got like five.
Oh, you're a loser.
I mean, I got like three Air Force Ones and then.
You're a loser.
Yeah, and then the dunks that I've gotten more this year because we had to get them for what we were wearing.
Right. Mm.
But yeah, how many pair do you have?
Infinity.
Mm-hmm. You?
Infinity.
All right. Hey, call us.
I got two pair of hustle shoes a week. Mm.
Let us know if you have over 50 pair of sneakers. My man's like 150.
Yeah, minimum.
I could have had a Foot Locker in my house.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
No, it's not.
It's normal for me.
That's taking care of your feet.
Exactly.
Because they say, well, some you wear them different ways.
Exactly.
All right, let us know. What's the number?
With the hustle shoes, once they broke, you're supposed to give them up. The creases broke.
What's the number?
Yeah.
How long you done had them? I could tell by the shoes.
These are my coaching sneakers. These are not my shoes I wear for shows. What's the phone number?
Oh, excuse me.
323-815-4204.
For what?
So how long you had those since you?
I've had these for about a month.
That's too long.
That's too long.
But I only wear these for coaching and working out.
Still too long.
Yeah, I don't understand that. And I'll clean these. I don't. Yours looks new.
They are.
I only wear white sneaks. The dunks are the first time I've worn.
Oh, you're not going to say nothing about mine?
Yeah, they're all right. I mean, they color. I like different color sneaks on
fresh
them.
Fresh ones, though.
See, he ain't going to say that far, see?
What?
Yeah. What?
Okay, so listen.
Those are old.
What, the ones you have on?
No, you.
Black History Month.
Mm-hmm. Last
day. I agree with you. It's been a horrible month.
Horrible.
It's been great.
It has not been a good Black History Month.
To bring the month down.
And I was thinking, okay, because that whole Cam Newton thing, is that in your news?
Killer Cam.
It's in what?
In yours. If you read the sheet.
Yeah. She thinks she got a rundown for it.
Stupid. Saved by the Bell. Caller.
You're on the air.
Fellas, what's up? It's Geoff Brown.
GB.
What's up, Geoff?
I am well. Geoff, what's up? Southside curly hair nigga, stand up.
Straight hair.
I have about 100 pairs of shoes. But not just like sneakers. I say about 35, 40 pairs of them are shoes. The other ones, you know, they hard bottom grown ass man shoes. I don't think it's the amount of shoes. It's what you paid for them when, and if you paid retail for them, are they worth more now? If you pay retail for them and they're worth less, there's no other way to put it. You lost. Because there's always a way. Somewhere there's a pair of your shoes sitting somewhere that somebody didn't count that's anywhere from 2/3 to 70% less than you should be paying for it, that's the shoe you're supposed to buy. If not, there's other places to put your money.
Yeah.
If you got a wall full of retail shoes, gentlemen, I submit to you that if you took half of that, you could own an apartment building by now.
Mm-hmm. Now, my sneakers are 90, the Air Force Ones, $90 plus tax, 107 or something like
yeah.
that.
You're losing.
I'm not paying no. People pay 400 and 200 and 350. That's crazy.
I mean, if you get them when they fall off the train, then exactly. that's a different situation.
I pay for them when you get the hookup.
Yeah.
Well, God bless the hookup. I'm not talking about Nike is not selling in stock on hookups.
Right.
And we are the number one. That's the thing. Being an end user, that's the bullshit. Retail is for suckers.
Mm-hmm.
Knowledge is the new money.
Absolutely.
So if you can find a way to hustle and get these shoes, that's one thing. If you got a closet full of retail shoes, you've been played.
So you mean sneakers that you paid at full price?
Right, yeah. Retail.
Well, I'm sorry. I was trying to understand that. He's smart.
And you know what? Okay, pay retail for the sneaker. But don't wear it. Pay retail for a sneaker that in 3 years is going to be worth 2, 3, 4 times that.
Mm. Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
So that's what these guys do.
The sneaker game is a real game.
Yeah. Would you guys buy the Trump sneaker?
I was just about to ask GB to expound on that.
Yeah.
For what?
Because Fat Joe just bought a pair.
Yeah, and they resell them online for like $5,000 to $6,000, $7,000, $8,000 grand on the resale.
Yeah, I'm not going to do that, but I think it's a sound move.
Mm-hmm.
It's something I would do. I'm not above it. I don't see a problem with that.
Now, why would you buy a pair of those sneakers for $8,000, $9,000?
Because Trump went to the sneakerhead convention and said, look at all you sneakerheads out there. I see you sneakerheads. He got on their team.
Take a trip on Fairfax and go to the Flight Club.
Yeah.
Michael Jordan. It's only two. He only has one here and one in New York.
Yeah.
And you'll see all his Jordans.
Yeah.
Limited edition.
Mm-hmm. And people buy those?
Yeah.
They
start at $800.
Big money.
Start at
$800. For a pair of...
Pair.
For a pair.
No, okay, wait.
Why?
A minute.
Why? I don't understand that.
Because.
Wait a minute. I think we're leaving out a group of people. How about the people who pay $4,000 or $5,000 for a pair of sneakers that have a particular artist's work on top of Nike?
Yeah.
Yeah. I would say the Asians and the Arabs.
Yeah. Yeah. You know the crowd.
Do they wear them or they just put them up?
He some just said he don't wear them. If they want to sell them, put them back on the market, they can. If not, they just hold them in their collection.
Yeah, or they'll wear them once or wear them to something to where other people will know what they are.
Mm-hmm.
That's a whole different thing than taking your ass down to Foot Locker at Christmas time and breaking yourself on new shoes.
That's why kids was getting jacked for their Jordans a lot.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And that's been a thing for a while, even with the clothing brand, with Supreme. Mm-hmm. It's just the name that you're paying for.
Yeah.
So you can get a hoodie like that, put Supreme on it, and you can buy it at their store for $225, mm-hmm. but you can sell it online for $1,200.
Yeah.
And it's another one called Essentials?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All these kids at the school have all these expensive sweatshirts on.
Department,
Because what was Drake? He had the owl. Was Drake the owl? Kanye had the teddy bear.
I was just looking at Jay-Z's sweatshirt, $335.
Get you one.
Are you kidding me?
No.
Like when Yeezy came out with his line of clothes, I remember I was in the shoe palace, and this woman was like, she got upset because they ran out of her size mm-hmm. for a T-shirt, and it just had holes in it.
Yeah.
Well, and her husband was like, yo, hold up. I'm not getting ready to pay $240 for that T-shirt.
Right.
And she wanted it bad. And he's like, "Yo, I can go to Target,
swap meet,
and get you a pack, T-shirt and cut you holes in."
Yeah.
And she's like, "It ain't the same."
No, because it's not the same. I'm not under the same trance.
That part.
Yeah. I'm not under the same socioeconomic trance.
Oh, okay, now is this a cross color line?
Yes.
Oh my God!
It's a big business.
First off, Lou D, please do not ever. I'll say this, and then I can't pretend I want to talk to you people anymore.
Respect that.
don't ever underestimate the fact that niggas don't want shit till they see white folks with it first.
Mm.
Everything you see, but the old Balenciaga this, because they saw some white man with it on.
Yeah.
That's real talk. Oh, I got to have a Bentley. Why? Why? Because you saw some white man driving it?
Mm-hmm.
You have no idea what the car does. You have no idea what it means for a watch to be accurate to 5 atmospheres. Mm. You don't give a shit about that. What you give a shit about is having people be able to look at you, defy the stereotype that they have in their minds, and you don't know how to make that not important. Again, I can't pretend I want to talk to you guys anymore.
GB.
Love you all, and especially Miss Morris.
Yeah, but the name brand is a big business.
Big business.
Because now when they have drops, they call them drops.
Yeah.
So when let's say when the Yeezys first came out, the gym shoe,
mm-hmm.
what people would do is they would set up there like 3 nights before the drop. And then they would go in. And if me and you go in, then I'm like, all right, you get all the 8s. I get all the 9s. You get all the 10s.
Mm-hmm.
Then we go online and then we sell them.
To our market.
Yeah.
8s and 9s.
Yeah. People that want a size 8, you pay $400 for them. So now I could go online and sell them for $1,600.
Yeah.
And all right, how do they, then you mail it to them?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You get you get familiar with the post office.
Yeah.
Well, that is crazy.
You're doing good business.
You have them, what people did when Supreme was up, because they got a thing, is that people will go in and they will buy like a small, medium, large, extra large.
Mm-hmm.
Then they'll come out. They'll pay retail for it. Then they'll go right down to Cancer's restaurant in the parking lot and resell it.
Fairfax.
To people.
So that's why all those people are lined up at the stores.
Yes.
They're waiting for what? To go in and
to buy it. But purchase. Now but all these, like Supreme and them, they all caught on now. So now when you come in, you only can buy one.
Mm-hmm.
You only can buy one size. That's it. So people used to go in and like give me like 4 mediums, give me 4.
Yeah, move around.
Yeah, and then you go down to the parking lot and then you can resell it.
Mm-hmm. So why doesn't Supreme just sell it for $1,600?
No,
because we already sold you the logo to keep it moving.
Yeah,
you can put the logo on anything.
You're already paying because we're already charging you $240 for a hoodie,
mm-hmm.
and you just paying for the name. That's it.
So just so I can walk out in public and be seen with it.
I got Supreme on.
And that makes you what? What does that do for you?
That is people are like, okay, well,
it feeds your fashion thirst.
People are like, your drip is nice.
Yeah.
Look at his drip. And that's what these young kids do.
Okay, so all right, so I guess I'm doing the same thing by repping Harvard Westlake. That's my drip.
Yeah.
Because everyone doesn't have this.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Except the coaches and the players.
Yeah. Right.
So
I wore this to Target, right? So the European lady kept looking back at me. She said, Ivory, you know that? I said, yes. I know Mark. Oh, yeah, my kids stood there. Yeah.
Right. Yeah, that's what they do. Yeah, Harvard Westlake. Yeah. 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 People were like, oh, yeah, you. The first thing they said is, do you work there?
Yeah.
Right. They never say, are you a teacher?
Yeah.
Just go, do you work there? Like, and right away I hear maintenance.
I said, yeah, I know Mark. Oh, yeah, my sons went there.
Oh, yeah. Ivory, they know Mark. They know say Mark and Brent. They were like, then you're a good person.
Yeah.
You get more conversation.
Once I said Mark, he was like, oh, okay, he's safe.
Right, right, right. You've been vetted by Mark.
Been vetted.
There you go, Mark. And see, that's what it is. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then Harvard Wesley, they're like, oh, and then they'll say, oh, do you have a kid that went there? And then then now you're a different kind of person.
Different kind of person.
So I guess that's the same thing with Supreme.
Yeah, exactly. But Geoff Brown made a good point, though. Because once we get a hold of something, we run it to the ground.
We turned it out.
Like, remember growing up, luxury cars we used to look at them like, wow, your mom got a Jaguar?
Yeah.
Wow, y'all got money.
Yeah. Y'all got a Cimarron?
Yeah, if you had a nice Rolls Royce, you'd be like, oh, they got money.
Right.
Yeah. Now, just all these cars, Rolls Royce, Bentleys, for black people, it's just common now. Yeah. Because we wear it out.
Yeah.
Like, just less than 10 years ago, and I can say honestly, I was one of the first with Craig. Flying private.
Mm.
Not everybody's flying private.
Yeah.
Nobody.
Well, not everybody.
Yeah, I'm in coach.
That fuel is expensive.
But look at this set, like at the Super Bowl this year.
Mm-hmm.
1,800 private jets.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
No, you know who got the most private jets?
Who?
A Floyd Mayweather fight.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
They fly from all over the world. If your plane is small, you got to go to the other airport to get that limo in. Because we got the big dogs in here today.
Wow. And he keeps his pilots on retainer.
On deck.
You up.
Caller, you're on the air.
The great TDP.
How you do, Mr. C?
New Dick.
What's up, Mr. C?
Great Geoff Arnold.
What's up, sir?
How y'all doing, man?
Good.
Better than I deserve.
Exactly. How you doing?
Better than I deserve. Better than I deserve.
Now, how many sneakers do you have?
Uh-oh, Mr. C.
Uh-oh. As a coach.
I used to have a lot.
What's a lot?
What's a lot?
What's a lot?
About 15 pairs.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. And what's the
that's a lot.
What's the max that you would spend on a pair?
About $250.
Okay.
Easy.
Okay.
Easy without thinking about it.
Wow.
Because see, here's the thing, Mr. C got big man feet, so you got to the more comfort costs.
I got wide feet.
Yeah, you got a duck.
Yeah.
Goddamn platypus over here.
Yeah, I can't wear it.
You say you got web feet?
Yeah.
You got web.
Yeah, that's why the Air Force Ones
work. This is awkward Negro over here.
Look out, ladies, so I can splash my feet.
That is so racist.
He still ties his shoes up in the bowl.
You don't?
What's going on, man? Yeah.
How's your family?
Yeah, Mr. C.
Everybody's doing well, man. Can't complain.
Awesome.
The daughter should be out, right? She's almost done, right?
Damn.
You keep more close tabs on than I am.
Oh.
She done turned the air on and blew our papers off the table. Fuck?
Trying to get
you
rid
didn't
of
test that today? What you been doing?
So what's up? Where you in? You're in D.C. Are you still in D.C.?
He made the move.
Yeah. I'm in the DMV.
Uh-oh. Oh, I'll be out there.
Why?
Be out there in D.C.
Are you coming out this way?
Yeah, D.C., right?
For what?
No, I'm doing the Mark Twain Awards. I'll be at the Kennedy Center.
To take a line from my man TDP. For what?
Yeah, if you're working out there, I'll
take him out. Show him
Saturday and Sunday. So Saturday will be my off day.
Take him out. Show him the town.
Allegedly.
Yeah.
Allegedly.
I want some crap.
So you going on the road?
No, I'm doing the Mark Twain Awards. So I get in Saturday and the show is on Sunday. So I'll fly.
So what's the Mark Twain Award?
It's when they honor.
Don't you invite Mr. C as your guest?
So the question I have, the follow-up question is, will he be there? Is it too soon?
No, Mark. Oh,
no. Too soon.
They're honoring Kevin Hart is receiving the award this year.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Those tickets are like $3,000.
Yeah.
What?
Huh?
You got no pool?
What,
you can't get a guest?
Yeah, I'm lucky to get in. My passport.
Soft.
You gotta get to know a security guard like.
Hey yo, man. Hey, check this out, man. Y'all will love this, man. So I was in Dubai last week.
Speak on it.
And I was streaming. Yeah, and I was streaming you guys' show live from Dubai.
What?
Yeah, while you guys were on air, I was able to still get the show out there, man.
Nice.
Did you put it on the big screen? Did you tell people to come join you?
No, y'all not that special. It ain't that deep.
You got arrested. That you would have got arrested.
Yeah.
It's not that deep, man.
Uh-huh.
So what was that? Was that your first time there?
In Dubai.
Was that your first
time? My first time flying internationally, man.
Now,
in Dubai, man.
Okay.
Was it hot?
Yes. Well, it's still winter over there, so it was about 75, 80 degrees while I was out there.
What rules did you have to follow that you weren't aware of?
Ain't no rules. I ain't have to follow no rules, man.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no?
You can't bring nothing back in the country from out there now. Don't do that.
Yeah.
But you had to act a certain way, right? I mean,
yeah.
You can't.
Hey, I act the same way in America as I act out of the country, man. You think I'm a looter?
That part.
I'm sure you
deaf to Allah.
No, you have respect for yourself, but I'm saying, did you notice?
You think I was out there doing commit crimes, man? No.
Deaf to Allah.
No, I mean, we've heard some people go over there and act the fool and act up. Like you stayed at a hotel, right?
No, I said the Airbnb.
Nah, I had a tent. Yeah, I was in a hotel.
Well, I mean, because there are different rules for men and women, right?
Yeah, he had two camels in a tent.
Yeah, exactly.
Two camels in a tent, yeah. Hey, man, I didn't see none of that stuff out there, man.
Now, you did. Okay, you were not briefed on anything you prior to going there?
No.
They didn't give you a booklet? Oh, it's not?
It's Americanized.
Oh, it is.
Yeah, TDP is America on steroids.
Absolutely.
Yep, I told you, yeah.
That's all it is.
Now, did you see a lot of us out there, a lot of black people when you was there?
A handful.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. A handful. Not okay. many. Not, okay. But yeah. A handful.
How was the food?
Great.
What did you enjoy most about it?
It wasn't America.
That part.
And I love the U.S., man, but it was just
okay.
Like,
expand on that. What do you mean? Okay, there wasn't America. Meaning was, what? You felt safer. No, you felt low.
I didn't have any. I didn't feel any animosity from anybody.
Right.
Right.
Okay.
From anybody.
No weight on the shoulder.
Yeah. You can relax. None. You can put your guard down.
Totally relaxed.
So no one looked at you odd or?
No.
No meme mugging. No. None of that.
Mm-hmm.
None of that.
Yes.
Not at all.
Cameras everywhere.
Yeah. You feel
cameras everywhere?
Everywhere.
Yes.
Hilarious.
Wow.
Nah, man. It was a lovely, it was a lovely sight to see, man. It was nice.
Now,
did you take a Rolls Royce cab? Did you get to experience that?
Nah, I didn't do all that. Just a quick little taxi to my hotel from the airport and, you know.
Okay.
And the hotel I was at, it was like, you know, next to another hotel so I can walk right through, you know, both hotels. And, yeah, man, just enjoy the experience.
Did they have a casino? Yeah.
Not before where I was at, no. Okay. Not where I was at.
Did you go by yourself?
No. Yes.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah. Look at you. All right.
And was it expensive?
Yeah, man. You know what? Okay, let me ask you. What's expensive to you?
Okay, you went by yourself. $9,000. How long were you there?
240 pair.
5 days.
Five okay. days. So I'm.
That's $1,000 a day.
Yeah. Is that what you count about $1,000 a day?
Yeah.
So 5,000.
I would say about 7.
Okay.
Okay.
But so, again, though, it depends on what one considers expensive, though.
Yeah.
So you can spend $100 in a day here in the States.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. I mean, quickly within 45 minutes.
Do you get more bang for your buck?
Oh, that's nasty.
Not really. That's not really. Hilarious. The temperature just increased in the room, I see.
Yeah.
So if someone in America say, I'm thinking about going to Dubai, they should have at least 7,000.
At least.
Does that include the airfare? What was the airfare?
I mean, everything. That, hotel, food, so all inclusive. Yeah.
So did you book it yourself or with a travel agent?
Myself.
Okay.
Good for you, player.
How long was the flight?
18. Now that's the thing, bro. You're looking at least 17 hours.
Yeah, 18
hours.
Yeah. Or did you fly Emirates?
At least.
Yeah.
You know, no layover.
International.
Either with a stop in between or nonstop. You're going to do at least 17.
I mean, how many hours are you actually on a plane?
17.
About 17.
He said that.
So what did you do the whole 17 hours?
Sleep.
Sleep and eat.
Yeah.
No reading, no looking at videos, no.
Porn, that's what
listen
she wanted.
To she wanted to
did you look at gang bangs on the plane?
Bang Brothers.
Again, it's time to play our game. I think.
Yeah, she's ready.
were you in?
Wait a minute, I got a question. Okay. You asked me the same stupid question. Mr. C, did you order room service? Did you order room service?
No, man, that's extra.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about.
That's all extra, man. Yeah. But you can get away without doing that, though. You don't have to really do all that.
Okay.
You can take food up to your room?
Yeah, but you don't really have to do. I mean, you don't have to order. I mean, if you want to just like, you know, you want to, be, Thurston Howell III and all that.
Right.
You do all that, but you don't really have to. You know what I'm saying? It all depends on your taste. You don't really have to do all.
Okay,
that.
American. Okay, I'm there. A hamburger, fries, and a drink. How much is that?
$23.
Well, and okay, so AE dollars. So
you got to transfer your money.
That's about $30 in their money.
Tax.
In U.S. dollars, that's like $8.
Oh, okay.
Oh, okay. So the food's not that expensive.
So you're going to go all the way to Dubai to go to McDonald's?
Right.
No. Yeah. No, I'm just saying a burger, eating at a restaurant, where here it would cost you maybe $40. It's only $20 there, right? For four course meal.
Well, you know, that money is you know, it's different. It's going to be.
You got exchange dollars.
Right, but I'm saying the exchange, the math comes out.
You don't have to exchange. You have to exchange. You can either do, you know, American money or their money. It all depends on what they're offering. So okay. If they offer you that option to do that, so you can choose their money and it'll still be equivalent to American dollars.
Okay. Yeah.
Did anything make you uncomfortable?
No.
Nice.
Nothing.
All right. If you were given one thing, a piece of advice you could give to someone if they were thinking about doing it, to do what or not to do?
Well, of course, don't get over there and think you're still in America. Yeah. Don't do that. Yeah. You know, don't clown. You know, because we have a lot of, you know, things that we can do here and get away with.
Mm-hmm. Such and as?
People just be like, well, I mean, you know, that American arrogance. So you can do something in America and still, folks will just look at you here and be like, oh, he's just, you know, he's just bugging out. Or he's just bugging out. Over there, you know, I wouldn't advise you to do anything. You know, out of ordinary over there, out of character over there.
Like cussing, getting mad and upset cussing and cussing someone out. You can't do that over there.
Yeah, I wouldn't advise that. Really? I wouldn't.
Public urination.
But again, too, though, why would you be upset, though? Because it really is the atmosphere and the environment isn't conducive for that.
Right.
Based on my experience. I'm just giving you my perspective.
Yeah. All right.
Because when you're over there, you're just an infidel. Yeah.
And I was over there handling business, so.
Uh-oh. That's right.
Well, good for you, man. Oh, thanks a lot. Mr. Appreciate that information. Thank you. 7,000, 5 to 7,000.
How y'all been?
We've been good.
We've been good.
Good enough to hang up on you right now, but thank you very much.
Hey, man, I appreciate it. See, and that type of attitude will get you messed up in Dubai.
Exactly.
Oh, it would.
Arrogant American right here.
Okay, I'll stay. All right, man. Much love. See you later.
Snatch your passport when you try to
succeed out the DMV.
Yeah, okay. Great call. So 5 to 7,000 if you think about going to Dubai.
Yeah. And no room service.
Yeah.
Now, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean.
But that's by yourself, though.
That's double that if you're taking your woman.
If you take your woman.
That's 15,000.
Yeah.
Now, would you expect her to pay for something? Or do you spend everything?
It depends.
Depends on what?
I mean.
If you bring your credit card?
No, if I'm asking her. I mean, if we're together like that.
Save by the phone.
If we're together like that. But if I'm a guy and I'm trying to take this woman somewhere, hey, let's go to Dubai.
But if you invite her.
Yes.
Yeah, if you invite her.
Is the whole trip on you?
Yeah, I would think so if I'm inviting her.
So all the meals, and all of that.
Hey.
Yeah, it's going to have to be.
Caller. You're on the air.
Gee.
What up, man? It's Poo Lee, man.
Poo Lee.
What's up, playboy?
Poo Lee, you sound like you in Dubai.
Teacher by day, stripper by night.
Hey, Lou, what's up with your boy, Matt Barnes, man?
He can't talk about that. He has a gag order in his mouth.
He signed an NDA. He can't talk about it.
Yeah, he has a gag order in his mouth.
No, it's been public now, so you can say it. He was going after the referees during the game that we played. It was the championship game for the league championship.
Yeah.
For our league. And Crespi, and he was chirping at the refs, and as he does, and he says that's what he does. Then one of our sportscasters, our announcers, young senior.
What was you doing?
I was over the bench, coaches. You know, we were just, got a tech. Nothing. All we saw was it was a tech.
You're on the high school bench now, too? You made it to the high school bench?
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. JV, freshman, we get called up. We continue. After our season is done, we go up to VAR and because most of, like, five of our players got called up to varsity.
Yeah.
So they're the scout team. Mm-hmm. So we get you know, we always help out, but all levels help out.
You ain't
help
out that night.
Yeah, TDP ain't have to go to do that with your current star, did you, TDP?
I'm going to say this to you, Poo Lee, because you could appreciate this, right? So back in the day, Crespi was a good school. I always heard of Crespi.
Oh, okay.
But here's the kicker that people don't talk about, right? So you know Derek Fisher, who used to be the president of the NBA, is now the coach at Crespi.
Right.
Yeah.
So you got this dude with your woman, your kids. He done already wrecked your truck. So you ain't mad at the referee. You mad at him.
Yeah. I'm fucking in your house.
Yeah, all that. Yeah. And he coaching your kid.
You trying to come at him in an indirect way.
Come on. They his kids now. He the coach. And that, yeah.
Hey, GD. What's up with the Bulls, GD?
Mm-mm. You know,
hey. We got a good team.
Hey, what y'all going to do with this? I mean, I know your Bears got the number one pick. What y'all going to do, bro? Y'all going to keep him?
You can't leave him dangling out there, man.
Okay.
You just got to, you know, like Ryan, like, you know, like the GM said, you know, if we're going to cut him, we got to cut him now. Because if you're going after Caleb, you know, it's going to be the same thing. I mean, Caleb is not going to come in and make that much of an impact, you know, right away.
Can I say this? Can I say this to Chicago? Scottie Pippen is back along with Jordan saying he's the GOAT. So.
Yeah, I got one more question for Lewis.
Because you know why? Because you stop fucking this, you know.
Hilarious. Yo, what up? What up, Poo Lee?
Marcus, stop fucking.
How do you see Cam Newton in that situation?
Oh, I thought it was some players. But
that whole team need to go to jail.
They said it was some adults that he was.
They need to go to jail.
Some hating motherfuckers. Sure.
Yeah, that's part. Yeah.
Those 7-on-7s be crazy, so you know that, man.
Oh, yeah. Competition, I mean, it used to be more controlled in the sense of players listen to coaches. There was a decorum. There was a certain unwritten rules. It was, you know, there just was sportsmanship. Now everything has crossed the lines. It's blurred.
Social media.
One reason I had to take a break from coaching, man, is the parents, man.
Yeah.
I had to take a break. I'd rather be – my method is way more important than sports, man.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and you have to be – the one thing I've learned with parents and players, the more consistent you are, the more they have whatever their attitude is, it falls off.
Mm-hmm.
If you're consistent,
I got to a point where I had no parents in practice, man.
Yeah, you have to be consistently. Like one guy asked me about his son. He said, "Well, I'm just trying to," because the son was paying attention to him. And I was like, "Come on!" I sat him on the bench. I was like, "Listen, man, you listen to us. You're not listening to your dad."
Yeah.
And then after the game, the dad was like, "Well, I was just trying to encourage him." And I was like, "He encourages himself by getting in a gym and putting in extra time. Is he doing that?" Dad's like, "No." I said, "Well, then that's their encouragement, not you. You're not at our practice. You don't know what to do." So after that, the dad was mean mugging me and all that.
Oh.
Usually the kid is usually cool.
I didn't get no call.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
He was mad at me. I didn't get no call.
I never thought I'd see the day
when
Chris, I would be a football school, bro.
Yeah, it's in the making. Everything
it just reversed. What happened? It just reversed from a football to a basketball to a football school.
Right, because, you know, when you have alumni that come back and ingratiate the school with, you know, a new field, lights and all that, that's a big difference. We only had day games because night games are too goddamn dangerous right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard y'all doing, man. Y'all doing great in football now. That's good, man.
That's good. Absolutely. Yeah. Things evolve, you know?
Yeah.
So, hey.
Have a great night, my boy.
You too, all man. Right. Take care.
Poo Lee.
Hey, so the whole Cam Newton thing. Okay.
I'm glad we couldn't hear it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Man, I'm glad we couldn't hear it. Trying to sneak it in all this. I'm listening. You gonna pay Ice Cube for that sample?
We probably did back in the day. Lewis, go ahead and you can set off the Poetess Report with the Cam Newton thing.
Well,
you gonna let him set it off?
Yeah.
We got a little wrinkle in the show.
Hilarious.
Yeah.
No, I guess it was a 7-on-7
thing.
They
need to go to jail.
And Cam Newton got jumped by 3 guys. I thought it was students at first, but then after more reports, it said it's
a coach.
It was some coaches.
There was one particular coach that he kept saying that, you know, over the years, they've been going back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
It started off competitive, but then Cam came with the, you know, I've been in the league, I got money.
That's true.
I pay for all of this.
True.
You know, and all that. You can't do this. And the coach was just like, yo, he just came that day. And he said, basically, I'm paraphrasing, he's like, I just got tired of it.
Mm.
Like, motherfuckers is always coming with
you the could've left.
And all of that. And he's like, yo, so, you know.
Could have left.
And that's the thing now. All these kids, there's no respect no more.
I mean, where are you at a point where you think you can go hands with a 6'5", 250 dude?
It's across the board. Did you see the one, not to cut that out of chain, but with Kevin Durant, the two white people, when he walked by?
Right.
She was like, bitch.
Yeah.
When he came back, oh, I just want to shake your hand. Oh, you call me a bitch. What's up? Like Russell Westbrook.
Yeah.
Somebody said something to him. He like, all right. But the one, the Los Angeles Ram cornerback, Mm-hmm. When that motherfucker was talking shit to him, and then my man was like, yo, fuck that security. And he jumped over the rail.
Yeah.
And he was like, yo, I'm here now. What's up? And dude was like, oh, would you yeah. hit me now?
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
He like, no, talk yeah. all that bullshit now.
Cowards.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's to me, it's just out of control.
Oh, you want to say something? The fuck?
Yeah, so it's just lack of respect. It's just, I mean,
yeah,
this
especially
world is,
from her.
Yeah. I mean, and it's across the board. It's across color lines. It's just human beings just feel they have a right to.
I'm going
to
say this. Cam Newton, their hat didn't move.
No.
That's all I know. That's fashion.
Yeah.
Y'all want to talk about his fashion? Goddamn it, that's fashion. Didn't move.
He was throwing, motherfucker.
He was throwing them. Strong, strong.
Chilla Cam.
So we just need to get
all
ourselves
All right, so
together.
Happy leap year.
Yes.
29 days.
Yeah. 29 days.
Real quick.
Damn.
So if someone was born on the 29th.
You got to change your birthday to the 1st or the 28th.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I do have a friend that was born on the 29th.
And then you got to.
And I think he celebrates March 1st.
They make them.
They make them?
Yeah. Cause it ain't no,
so what about on the birth certificate? I mean.
They change it. Legally.
What?
Well, no, it's for
I
me.
I didn't know that.
You know now.
Also on leap year, in Ireland, they have a tradition where women can propose to men
I'm going
on
up
that
there.
Day.
I'm going up there. Wow. No, bitch. Next. Jesus, how long am I going to be here?
Would you ever propose to a man?
No.
Why? Would you? Well, I thought about it. You know, Code 3's on a cruise.
I didn't want to take the rejection.
Yeah. You know? Fuck that ring cam.
So, leap year happens when we add one day to the end of February in order to align the calendar with the Earth's orbit.
Mm-hmm. So how often does the leap year
once
happen?
Every 4 years.
You didn't know that? No. Olympics.
It's a leap year. You didn't know that?
I knew it was a leap year this year. I didn't know it happened every 4 years.
So it's 366 days this year.
I'm kind of for that 29th day in February.
You're for it?
Yeah.
Why?
Because no more leap
girl,
year?
Yeah, if your girl is born on the 29th, then for, you know, just that 1 year, you just can say happy birthday to her.
Yeah.
You ain't got to buy beautiful. No gift or nothing.
Yeah. Bitch don't get old. Yeah. It's a blessing.
Age like, well, I was going to say
she be like,
dogs,
you forgot my birthday.
But
7 years for a dog right. is 1 year.
She be like, you forgot my birthday. Be like, no, bitch, I didn't.
No.
Your birthday's in 4 years.
Yeah. I'll see you then.
All right.
Man kills a coyote with his bare hands.
Oh, come on. Video.
I want to see video.
A coyote that a hiker killed with his bare hands after being attacked.
It was a pup.
And bitten on the leg.
I don't believe it.
While in the woods, the hiker pinned the coyote down.
Yeah,
by
whatever.
Its
that video
neck
to it?
And killed it with its bare hands.
Yeah, whatever.
Wow. You don't believe that?
No. European lies.
Yeah. I want to see video.
Yeah, got to see video. It didn't
Turns
happen.
Out the coyote had rabies.
Ah.
That's why they attack.
Really?
Any animal. When they got rabies.
Why? Is that does something to
their
brain?
They're going out. Yeah, exactly.
They're going crazy.
Mm-hmm.
You know my favorite animal that is?
What?
The Komodo dragon.
Mm.
Why?
Man, the way they just.
He's the most savage killer on the planet.
I saw a thing where an alligator had eaten a baby hippo, and the hippo's.
Oh, yeah, you saw that one?
Yeah, I saw
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah, just swam hippos that motherfucker. Just,
yeah.
Gang beat him up. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You ever watched them? It's like the way they kill other animals?
Oh,
they
I
wash
saw.
Wash them and clean them, they just eat them.
I saw.
Don't season them.
I saw two bears fighting, a video with two bears fighting.
Yeah.
And then the people in the comments were like, somebody should break it up. Somebody was like, oh, that's rude. You know,
it was a black bear and a brown bear.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, that's yeah. racism. They yeah. don't like each other.
And then they were like, yeah. I just hate that people sit there and video. And other people are like, what are they supposed to go
yeah,
break it up?
Right.
Hey guys, stop
that's
that.
It's stupid.
But I love it though when they attack the humans, so I love that.
With the bears?
Oh yeah, elephants.
Yeah, I like it too.
When
the animals
get
win.
Fed up at the circus, and they start smashing
oh, yeah.
them.
No, my favorite.
Yeah, when they
is,
do shit when they ain't got no business.
Yeah,
doing.
I'll be like, oh.
My favorite one's a big ass tree, right? And they out there with the bison, so the old man get caught up with the bison, trying to run around a tree. Man, he hit his ass all up in that goddamn tree. He's like, oh my God!
Yeah, they
what about the bullfighters that get messed up?
Yeah, leave nature, man. Leave nature alone.
You know, right. got some hops too? What? Cheetah.
Oh, Cheetah?
Oh, man. He had that gazelle. That motherfucking cheetah had him in his mouth and then hopped up on the tree mm-hmm. with the gazelle. I was like, oh.
And of course, everyone remembers the video where the elephant, the person that killed the elephant.
Oh, yeah. Got the wife.
Yeah. And then they tore up the funeral.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. I love that.
Okay. Woman arrested after being spotted driving with her son in the trunk.
Oh, yeah.
Did you hear about that?
The son was alive?
Yes. So Gwinnett County police were alerted about an alarming video that circulated on social media that showed a young black kid riding in the trunk of his mother's car. The video shows a gray Dodge with an out-of-state license plate rolling down the street, a 12-year-old in the back holding on to a piece of furniture. to keep it from falling out. So basically, she put him in the trunk to hold a chair.
Good for her. Good ingenuity.
She didn't have no rope.
Yeah. My son is the rope.
And I done paid $400 for this, and I'd be damned
if I lose it.
She can lose him, but not
can't lose my furniture. Yeah.
So you can see in the video that there's a chair and the kid sitting back in the trunk.
Boy, if you
up
drop
against
this
the chair,
I'm going to fuck you up.
Now, real up.
Do we have that video?
No, I got it. I'll find it.
Nah, we all right. We know what happened.
So she, of course, got arrested.
Oh.
And,
that's parents.
Racism.
She's out on bail.
And so what? Did they arrest her and put her in the trunk? Drove her to the police station?
Bam, 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 bam.
That's parenting.
That's what it is.
Can't have the fuck,
man. Well, okay. So back in the day, when you went to the drive-in movie, did you ever hide in
the
trunk?
In a station wagon? Everybody in the back with your pajamas on. Yes. What are you talking about?
Oh, yeah. Many aunts had their feet on me while they sat and laid on the floor.
We went to go see The Exorcist in the station wagon. Everybody put your pajamas on. We're going to make this popcorn, fry these wings.
How many times have you helped somebody move and you had to be the person that hold the shit?
Yeah. Yeah, you had to sit in the back, but not in the trunk.
But now here's the kids that don't know, right? So when they pull up, to pay for the movie theater, right? So it's, what, $5 for adults and free for kids? Two adults. We back here, too! Yeah, give me some more money, man.
That's hilarious.
Yeah.
Damn.
Oh. That sounds nasty. Sounds like you're gargling balls. Yeah, I see your other
hilarious.
Side.
It's hilarious. Gargling balls.
Gargling balls.
Okay, two bongs up.
Well,
Tyler Perry's Mea Culpa.
Oh, God.
Did anybody see
I've
that?
I've not seen it. I mean, it's hard to watch it when everyone talks about it all the time.
Okay.
Did you
he
see
stole
it?
No.
I didn't see it.
It's a stolen
Did you see
idea.
It? Is it? It wasn't that great. The writing was terrible.
I saw the trailer and I was like, okay, he stole from Jagged Edge.
Mm.
Glenn Close, Jeff Bridges. We see
it. Well, despite.
Did you see it?
I did.
And?
I thought the writing was trash.
I keep hearing about the sex scene.
I felt like. I was hoping that Kelly Rowland didn't give in to this guy the whole time, because he was a charmer, a sex addict, and
sounds
she's
like
a
hate.
Strong attorney, and he was her client. So I was like,
"This is a funny, this is a funny this guy." This is
that
story.
Right. Yeah.
She like, "Don't fuck him." Like,
please don't fuck him.
Yeah.
Please.
So
let me do it.
I give it a two bongs down.
Oh,
despite the negative reviews, it did receive high ratings.
Mm. Nah, 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 nah.
So, Donnell Rawlings' comedy special, A New Day, came out on Netflix.
Okay,
I give that two bongs up. I thought it was funny.
Nice.
It's part of the whole Dave Chappelle's home team lineup. Did any of you all see that?
I have not seen it yet. No. I heard a lot of people said it was mild.
Mm.
I mean, M-A-L-D.
That's the new moniker.
Oh, wow. It wasn't a hack?
No, I mean, that's what I heard. I haven't seen it. I mean, it's hard
that's
for me to watch.
That's his new label now. He's mild.
It's hard for me to watch, you know. But we, who else had one? Mike Epps, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. I thought his was good, too.
His was funny.
I enjoyed Donnell Rawlings. He looked so much like Dannon Green. I was like, oh, yeah. God.
Dannon looks like him.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, good for him.
But he was good. Also, Wendy Williams. Boom! Where is Wendy Williams?
Who gives a
So
fuck?
Has that aired?
Yeah. It has aired. I watched it today. And a lot of people were saying, were upset, accusing, I guess, the family and the producers of it being exploitative
exactly
to Wendy Williams.
She wanted that.
But I thought it was a good idea to put it out because you saw how going, living a hard lifestyle, doing drugs and drinking alcohol, you can end up like that because she was just diagnosed with alcohol-induced dementia. And she was die-hard alcoholic.
So when
and,
you say die-hard, what is
like
that?
Like drinks hard. Every day to the point where...
Look at her.
Blackout.
To the point to where she is now.
You no mean, was it liquor or beer? Or
liquor, wine. I think her choice was vodka.
So you say, okay, when you say drink a lot, so you saying she started in the morning, she's at night.
Never stops.
It was as bad as it bringing on the dementia. Like she
blackouts?
Was drinking everything.
She pickled her liver.
Yeah.
Jeez.
I'm just asking.
So the other interesting thing about the documentary is her guardianship. Like,
Froze her account.
They froze her account. They took her family.
Wells Fargo.
They didn't give...
Stage
they,
coach.
Well, according to the documentary, the family doesn't have access to her right now. She's in a rehab and care facility.
No, it's over.
So you
watched the documentary?
I did.
I watched some of it, too. And even through her dementia, she's still a nasty person. She's still a nasty person.
Yeah, she was...
what she was talking to
us. Yeah, the way she talks to her staff was... Still.
So her guardianship, you mean someone is...
So in
her.
The state of New York, they hired a professional person to do the guardianship. He has no, or she has no relation to her. So her son had power of attorney, but her son decided to take her from New York to Florida to be with her family to help her stop drinking. So when she went home to her family, she was actually getting better. She gained weight. She was in better spirits, but the judge revoked his power of attorney because he did that. So I didn't know it was illegal to take somebody out of state that's mentally.
Did she have a will or anything? I mean, not she's not dead.
She
but
says
what,
to me, despite her dementia, she still was cognizant of stuff that was going on.
I'm trying to figure out who. Okay, so I'm starting to get dementia. So someone finds out, or I go to the doctor, who
she
reports her?
She goes to the doctor because they put her in rehab. So the doctor in rehab did a brain scan and found that she had aphasia. I can't think of it. It's the same thing that Bruce Willis has.
Yeah.
Frontal global. Is that
frontal lobe cortex?
I said frontal global. Frontal temporal.
Oh, I like temporal.
Dementia. Aphasia.
But can I say this to the point when, remember when she was Lady Liberty and she fainted?
Yeah, that was.
That's when it started.
First indication right
Absolutely.
There.
Yeah.
That's when it
so
started.
So the doctor finds out, they find out, they diagnose her with that, and then. What happened? Then someone contacts who?
So
the state?
She's still, I guess so, but she was still living on her own in her apartment in New York, and she had, you know, people working for her.
And her ex-husband?
He wasn't really in the picture, but part of that divorce and losing her mother, all of that played into her depression and her drinking.
Yeah. It's coming for you soon.
It's what?
It's coming for you soon.
Right around the corner.
What?
Yeah, a lot of people are saying that, you know, this is karma for her.
Absolutely it is.
As nasty as she was to people, exposed.
But here's the thing, right? So, rest in power, Machiavelli the Don. When they leaked his music, we had the original cut with Why You Turning On Me, where he says her name. And fuck you, and I pray you choke on the next dick down your throat for turning on me. But once they put it out, they bleeped her name out. No. Mm. So we already knew about her back then.
Yeah.
Hmm. Yeah. Well, she.
When Wendy called.
Now, so her money is still able to take care of her. The
absolutely.
People who
yeah.
She. But says it's frozen. In the documentary that she has millions and that they froze her bank account because somebody was mishandling her funds.
Her husband.
Yeah.
Okay.
But you know where so she got the game from. So now she's in a care facility to help her mental illness and for her alcoholism.
But you know her gave her the game in radio? Howard Stern.
Yeah.
She was a Howard Stern student. So she made money. Mm-hmm. She made money.
She was on for 11 years.
Yeah. On the TV?
Yeah. She
mm-hmm. And yeah. the radio after that. New York yeah. radio, you're in the top market. You got the number one show. You're already making millions a year.
But she had to go to Philly.
Yeah, when she started, yeah.
Puff Daddy said, bitch, you got to go. She went to Philly.
Wow, it's sad.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's sad. I don't, what's so sad about it? I don't, I mean, I'm people, not I mean, cheering I that it's, you I know. Am. That,
you're cheering?
Oh, yeah. Out of here.
No. Nope.
When she came after people, she didn't give a fuck yeah, about people. When bad Whitney built, was going bitch. Through hers. She put Whitney out there. Whitney had to call in and like
bitch like a dinosaur with the tail kicked off.
Yeah, she went in on a lot of people.
A lot of people. And she said, but she said it before this one when they did her documentary. She said that was her job. She said she wanted to be known as the person that if you came to for me to interview you, I wasn't gonna talk about what your publicist or your manager wanted. I wanted to know the dirt on you. And you had to explain yourself on that. Mm-hmm. And she would embarrass people. They were like, yo, we're not talking about that. Oh, no, this is what we want to talk about.
Yeah, she was trying to get the dirt.
Yeah.
And now she's close to dirt.
Yeah. Exactly. And the most endearing part, too, was
yeah,
when
whatever.
Black China was on there with her and speaking to her, went to visit her in that shape.
So?
But anyway, that is the poetry.
That's it?
Wow. Oh, rest in peace to Richard Lewis.
Yes.
Yes.
Comedian Richard Lewis.
He's a good guy.
Yeah, he had a heart attack, and he had he
put
was
his
suffering
picture
from
up.
He was suffering from forgot the disease.
Yeah, let me 76. Pick his picture. He played in I loved him on Curb Your Enthusiasm. Mm.
But did you see the episode? It was episode 3 when he was in the golf cart, and they both was talking about who was gonna die first.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Richard Lewis was like, I like what you just did. He's like, you know. If you die before me, I'm going to put you in my will. And they were like, no, you're going to die before me, I'm going to put you in my will. Yeah. So it went back and forth. It was a funny bit. And now it's like.
Wow.
But he finished the season, though, so that was good.
Richard Lewis.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, he was one of them, who say, caffeine comics. You know, he was with the jittery jokes. And
he was actually the first to bring out the legal pad on stage.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Yeah, so, I did his show. He had a sitcom.
Yeah.
I didn't want up on his show.
That's why it didn't last.
Yeah, I thought he was funny. Rest in peace to Richard Lewis. Yeah. All right. Well, that's funny. It for the Poetess Report.
Was good.
Playoffs? Don't talk about playoffs.
When you just talk about practice, we sitting here, I'm supposed to be the franchise player, and we're in here talking about practice.
If I wish one of your guys had children, if I could kick them in the fucking head and stomp on their testicles, so you could feel my pain, because that's the pain I have.
I wish I was 50 years younger and I'd kick your ass.
You won't do shit.
Oh, we look like the damn Bad News Bears.
Get all them ingredients in there.
I've been drinking a lot of Cherry Coke, and I've been thinking about you, but I'm not supposed to.
You turn up your lining.
Yeah.
Huh? He made me feel bad one time because he was like, they pour that on the battery to clean the battery.
They do.
They do.
It was on sale, though. All right.
No, since we're on the topic, you know these right here?
Mm-hmm.
That glaze that's on there?
Yeah.
That comes out of antifreeze.
Yeah.
Now, you know when they de-ice the planes, that ingredient in there, but the ingredient they, after they de-ice it, then they spray to keep the ice off the plane is coated with that.
So when you eat all that, your feet don't web up or nothing?
Tita Sports Ticker.
It's the first time I've eaten it in like years.
Philadelphia 76er news.
What's up?
Joel Embiid.
Is he back yet?
Plans to return this season.
After
knee injuries. Oh. Suffered a month ago, but he says no timeline. Sixers are currently in sixth in the Eastern Conference. So you guys, if the playoffs started today, you guys would have a home court, no play-in at the sixth position.
No.
So do you want him to come back, or you think y'all good without him?
Hey, man, I'm going to be honest.
Y'all ain't won in a long time. I'm just asking. Do y'all need him?
Yeah, we need him.
Okay.
But he goes down about this time every year, though.
I know. I mean, he just—
Is it contract year?
No, it's just these big guys, man. They just—
I think right now, at his age right now, and it may sound stupid, I think his body's just starting to really catch up.
Starting to wear
I
down.
Think he messed up from the first time he talked about how he wanted Rihanna. He was cursed.
Yeah, I remember that LD.
He was cursed. As soon as he put All it out
star,
there.
Yeah.
All right, Hup one. Your girl from Iowa, Clark, Caitlin. Clark,
yeah.
She's going to forgo her last season at Iowa to enter the WNBA. Yeah. Is that a wise move? Because if she stays in college, she can make more money.
Well, I mean, she wants to be a pro. Her goal is to be a pro, and then she can make that money in WNBA. And then
Indiana Fever has the first pick.
Head over to overseas. Yeah, well, I'm sure they're going to take her.
Okay.
I mean, I don't know. I shouldn't say that.
But you know what, though? I think they're going to make her an example. She's going to be the first high-paid female WNBA player.
They're gonna raise the roof for her.
Is she going number one?
Yeah.
She's projected.
Okay.
Indiana, I mean, why not take her? You know? Hometown girl.
Because there's only a few WNBA players that's making $1 million now. So she's going to come in. She's going to be like, you know, take it to that next level. $5 million.
Her too.
Yeah. They're going to pay her.
Mecole Hardman. You know who that is?
No, I don't.
He was traded from the Chiefs to the Jets.
Oh, yeah, my man. Yeah, he was talking trash.
Then back to the Chiefs.
Yeah, I read that.
Suspended.
Oh, wow. Oh,
wow.
That he leaked game plans to other teams while he was playing for the Jets.
As he should.
Games in questions are the Eagles versus the Jets and the Chiefs versus the Jets.
Ooh.
Do we got a smoking gun here?
Well, that was the first game the Eagles lost.
Exactly.
The Jets. But my man, I don't know if it was the punter that went at him, because he said something about—
McAfee?
No, the punter who punts for the Jets.
Oh, okay.
Said that, yeah, well, don't believe everything you say, because he was talking about how the Jets, they do whatever they want over there. My man was like, don't say that. Don't take that from a guy you got beat out by a free agent.
Yeah.
After being paid millions.
Oh, okay.
Everybody's beefing.
Yeah.
Everybody's sensitive. Everybody's beefing.
But I said, even if he did leak plans in the 2023 season, Aaron Rodgers went down the first game. So you guys are pretty, you know, pretty not in contention to do anything.
Right.
You know, so good for him. Wow. Caller, you interrupted Teeter Sports Ticker.
I am so sorry, Mr. Teeter.
Hey, Seymour. Bless your heart.
What's up, Seymour?
May I add to your segment?
Absolutely.
You know, our girl Shikari signed a $20 million deal with Nike.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, now.
Okay, track and field.
Yes, absolutely. I'm so proud of her. I like her shake back, you know.
That's right.
Now she can get all the weed she wants.
Exactly. Really, Lou.
So Seymour, how you doing? Your boy's not
I'm
here.
Fine. Dannon. That's not my boy.
Well, when we say that, we mean that in a sarcastic
wet mouth rascal.
You know, when black people say that.
And you're not my boy either anymore, Mr. Dick.
Anymore.
Oh, hi, Dale.
Hey, Seymour.
Well, that's all right, because Code 3, she asked me, what happened? What did you do to Seymour? She's not your girl anymore. Code 3 been teasing me about it. I think she liked Dannon.
Well, you need to apologize, Lewis.
I did already.
You need to do it
no,
again.
No, you never have.
I did.
Publicly.
Never have.
On the record.
On the record.
On the record.
On the record.
You stuck your big nose in something that didn't have anything to do with it. And let me also let you know that you messed up my giving to your show. So, Teeter and Jeff, I haven't been donating because that guy sitting in the middle with that big nose came at me about something that had nothing to do with him.
Seymour, Seymour, Seymour.
Excuse me. Hold up.
To Lewis's defense.
Hold up.
To Lewis's defense.
Seymour, go ahead.
Lewis did apologize. He did apologize. He admitted he talked to Speedy.
Ain't nobody asked you.
And Speedy was cool with it. I don't know. Maybe you missed that episode, Seymour, but he did apologize.
So check yourself on that, and it's okay.
Well, hold on. No,
you're going to get back in trouble.
No, wait, Seymour. Wait, you said.
You apologize to me.
No. First of all, hold your
good
horses.
Good point.
Evidently.
How do you know she ain't got camels?
I don't know what she got. Okay. But all I'm saying is that just.
I got $100. I'll tell you that.
Well,
Seymour.
I thank you for your apology. Hey, this is for the show.
Seymour, my Cash App is TDP Life at Cash App. Since I didn't know this was going on.
Mine is Armor Comedian. So.
Let me put mine out there for the record.
My Zelle is the same. So.
Capital TDP Life. Now. Seymour, at Cash App.
Well, you gotta stop.
Hold up, Seymour.
I don't do Cash App. I'm a PayPal kind of girl.
Okay, right, so then send it to the show.
Did I speak?
Okay.
Seymour, you have to. You've been really. You talk about people.
Mm.
You've been really lately mean, and before you were not that mean and aggressive.
Lately.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I've noticed that.
I have to agree.
You've been cussing and you cutting people out. You would
I'm
never.
Wrong.
No. Just, can I say, can I speak?
You call that bitch a bitch.
No, I did not.
Call him a big nose bitch.
So, and I was a little taken aback because I saw you in a different light, Christian woman, and then now lately.
Christian suck dick too.
actually, I don't, Peter. Yeah. But
well, bless your heart.
Hold up, can we hold on.
I'm not responsible for whatever you created in your mind about who I am. The fact of the matter is, sir, you don't know me.
Ooh. And that's vice versa. Hold up, Seymour. That's my point. You don't know me either. So,
cis male.
But yet you come and say certain things off the top of your dome. So it goes both ways. And I just feel sometimes lately it's been a one-way thing with you.
Mm. Featuring Al Hudson?
Yeah, this is just a show. So check yourself. I've always liked you.
I thought you were a nice person.
But, you know, I felt you came at my friend, and I came back to defend him. And then when I found out he was okay with it, I apologized. You didn't hear it. So there we are.
Well, let her hear it now.
Yeah.
What?
The apology. Let her hear it.
I'm not
say her name.
Why? See,
ego.
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 You stopped our donations because of your ego.
She was not donating.
Yeah. Yes, I was. I was actually going to donate that same day that you came at me, sir. I was in the eight.
Well, then you can donate and say that you want the funds to go to them. I don't even take the funds that are donated.
Mm.
So let's check yourself on that.
Oh, girl.
It goes to them.
Girl.
If I need funds, I just borrow $200 from Geoff. That's how that goes.
Yeah, top that.
Yeah, so I don't need the fuck. I say, no, I don't want him. I just go to Geoff and say, can I borrow $200? But I apologize, Seymour, because I really like
you. There you go.
And I apologize. And if whatever I said, I meant it. But listen. I'm just kidding.
Okay.
No, I apologize. I really like you. Code 3 likes you. We talk about you all the time. And, she's always asking about Seymour.
Well, they don't have sex.
Tell Code 3 that I pray for her. And that I pray that one day you would do the right thing and make her an honest woman because I believe she wants to be married.
Now she heard this.
Now I'm in your business.
Yes, she does.
Now
she really loves you. She's just going to say now. Seymour is smart, da da da, and then she's gonna look at me like, because my mother didn't say the same thing, my sister didn't say the same thing. Go on and go ahead and marry this girl, because this girl's the one for you.
You're stupid.
And I would say go into counseling and make sure that you're fully healed, because I think that's part of the holdup.
Good call, Seymour. Good call.
All right, let me go put my clothes back on, because she didn't just took everything off and just.
Let's ask Alicia how she feels about that.
That's what I do. Go cover yourself, Lou, and blow your nose.
Blow your nose. All
right, so.
That's anti-Semitic.
Yeah. No, first of all, where are you traveling to next?
Not to see you.
Yeah.
My birthday is Monday, and I normally do trips for my birthday, but we had a death in the family, so we're trying to figure out, you know, how to navigate that. Actually, he lived out in Lomita.
Okay.
So we're trying to get that thing organized. And but I wanted to say about that Cam Newton thing, TDP.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Listen. They're all, oh, Cam is 6'6". I'm like, is he 6'5 or 6'6"?
Both.
Did y'all notice that Cam did not throw a single punch?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was Steven Seagal in them.
Did you all also see the punch that he ate? And yeah. He was just, if they don't cast Cam in a Marvel movie, okay.
Good point.
Okay.
Good
and
point.
I'm going to tell you, the hat, I think that's where his strength comes from, Peter.
It didn't move.
But, you know, didn't move at all. And I think he was trying to check one of his friends that ran up that was throwing, hey, trying to calm them down.
Yeah.
But I thought that was insane. But people, these kids, and those are not kids. They just look like children compared to Cam Newton.
Absolutely.
Hey, I wanted to ask you a question, Seymour, because Mr. C had mentioned you travel a lot. So have you been to Dubai yet?
I have.
Okay, so he said, now did you go by yourself?
No, I went with some friends.
Now, mm-hmm. He said 5,000 to 7,000. Is that, was your experience as nice as his?
Yeah.
Well, we used a travel agent, and it could have been about sad, but I also went to Africa twice last year, and so that was definitely more than my trip to Dubai.
Okay. Now, how much was the trip to Africa?
And then I went to Tanzania.
How much the trip to Africa was? To Tanzania?
No, I used to pronounce it that way, Teeter. It's pronounced Tanzania.
Tanzania.
I actually went to Zanzibar, the little island off the coast of Tanzania.
Zanzibar.
Yeah.
Okay. Tanzania.
Now, you can help us in this situation. So, did you understand what Tiffany Haddish was doing when she went to Israel? Did you understand
her? Absolutely not. I felt like she was tone deaf, and you know, I pray that she don't get stuck over there. Is she still over there?
I don't know. I was just wondering, since you're a traveling lady, she had a great experience and that. Did you have a great experience in Africa?
I did, but you know what? I don't want to offend anybody. I don't know if you have any listeners that are African.
I am.
What I realize is, you know how you're my brother, you're my sister, you know, skin folk over here. Mm-hmm. We do that. They don't do that in Africa.
Yeah.
The guy that's, you know, like, let's talk about West Africa. Nigeria, Ghana, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
The Nigerian don't look at the Guyanian like, oh, that's my brother. No, I'm Nigerian, you're Guyanian. I said, we do this brother sister stuff over here. They don't do that over there in Africa.
Right.
Or the gentleman in East Africa, the Tanzanians, they're not, oh, yes, you're my brother. No. And not saying, oh, I'm not going to generalize, so please don't be offended if we have any listeners that are of African descent.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we romanticize, I'm going to go back to Africa. I would love to try to catch Dr. Umar, because, you know, he's always talking about he's a pan-Africanist, everything right. Like that.
Marcus Garvey.
Some of them don't view us like that. We are a lick for some of them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just want to get over. And I know I don't want to generalize and say they're all scammers, because we know we got scammers over here. It's different, y'all. It's a beautiful place. But you really got to be on your P's and Q's because, okay, let's say
you want to buy some
land. And your U's and V's.
Let's say the land is $12,000. Oh, TDP, oh, you're American. Oh, the land is now $35,000. You know what I'm saying? They're going to up the price. They're going to hustle your ass.
Yeah.
Now, and they won't give you dual citizenship.
Well, some places, I believe Ghana offered it up. And then I got offended a little bit, y'all, because there was a gentleman in one of these groups, and he was African, talking about we, black Americans, y'all need them. Y'all need us for culture. I said, you think we need you? The people who actually sold us into slavery, we don't need y'all for culture. That shit pissed me off so bad. I felt like it was so disrespectful.
Yeah, you should have called them in the kata.
But this is the other part.
You keep saying a kata.
You know, like, they talk about how we don't have culture. And I realize that the black culture, what are two things, y'all, and y'all, you know, gentlemen, y'all know we can't be. There are two things. We know we can't be ashy, and we know we can't be musty.
Mm.
But that's a part of our black American culture, okay?
Well, Lewis is defining all the odds.
Yeah. No, Dannon is the ashy one.
Yeah, he's ashy. Yeah. He's ashy.
But yeah, it's a beautiful place. And like I said, I don't want to generalize. I hope I don't offend anyone that's probably African.
No, they call us a katas.
You know,
that color.
Yes. Is that the term for cotton picker, TDP?
No, that's a derogatory term. It's like calling us a nigger, a jigaboo, and all that. They call us a cotters and jeers.
Okay, jigaboo.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So when I'm in the African market, I hear him saying that shit. I go over and check. I'm like, motherfucker, I know what that means, exactly. You punk bitch.
Yeah, I would definitely want to go back and visit again. My visa for Zanzibar is still good through December. But I want to go to South Africa. So I just don't have that, you know, romanticized, oh, I got to go back to the motherland, because it's not like, oh, we miss y'all. Welcome home. Right. Nah, bro.
Right.
Maybe it is in some other parts of the way I've gone. I'm like, it's beautiful. I'm glad that I went. But no.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much. And again, I apologize and thank you. Welcome back. And go ahead and donate for the film.
Wow. I accept your apology, Lewis, and I accept your nose. Y'all have a blessing.
Won't he do it?
I accept your nose. She slid that in there. Hey, she's funny.
Touché.
Very funny.
She's funny.
She's an
funny.
Apollo legend.
She is Seymour. Moore. So, hey, I'm Lewis Dix.
TDP.
Geoff Arnold.
And this show is flying by, even without Dannon.
We didn't finish Teeters, did we?
No, we didn't.
Okay, I'm sorry. You were at Hut 3. You were at Hut 3.
Hut 3! I like that, LD. And I just want to get into a tiny surprise marriage.
Oh, he got married?
Yeah, he got a surprise marriage. Atani.
Dodgers.
Dodger Spring training.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Got married. So did he marry an American?
Found a nice Japanese girl.
Oh, is she from Japan? Or she was from here?
Found a nice Japanese girl.
Good for him.
See, y'all don't travel much out here. You know there's a Thai town?
Mm-hmm.
That's over next to East Hollywood. There's a Thai town over there. So there's a lot of good eating and a lot of good women over there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you should go over there and check it out. Find your nice little Thai restaurant.
Get you some noodles.
Yeah. Thai food be killing my stomach.
Oh, my.
I like fat burger and a shake dome.
Yeah, you can go right up the street and get that, too.
Eating red vines.
No. Yeah, you're right. Okay, you're right. I had P.F. Chang's. They got good egg rolls.
Yeah.
P.F. Chang got some good egg rolls, man.
How you know you weren't eating cat?
Yeah. You get the vegetables.
Fried.
I didn't hear no meow.
Yeah, it's wrapped in pigeon skin.
It's so funny. You know, Lou is babysitting his mom's dog.
Hilarious.
Tonight. And it's the second dog.
I thought you was going to say he was babysitting his mom.
No, you know, the first dog died.
That's a different movie.
The first rescue dog died.
Wow.
Rescue dog?
Yeah, she had a rescue dog. And
she got rid of you for a rescue dog?
No. Damn, what was funny was how the dog died.
That was in the papers. That was in the court papers and the documents.
Lou was over there taking pictures of, you know, kids like take pictures.
Photo shoot.
So he was taking pictures of the dog, but the dog wasn't moving.
So he kicked it.
So he realized, he called me and said, you know, whatever the dog's name
is. Sound like that?
Moving. And I was like, well, maybe he's gone. And come to find out, he was dead.
Mm-hmm.
And how he died was interesting because the exterminator, I guess, came there.
Oh.
And he was licking the...
The baseboards?
Yeah, and I said, well, I guess it works. Not bad.
No more pests.
That could be a lawsuit.
Oh, shut up.
I think
put
that's
these ideas in his son's head.
As an animal lover.
Well, you know.
Lawsuit.
But she got another one, so, you know.
Same effect if she uses the same exterminator.
Right. Call him back. I got another rodent in my house.
Lou was like, that's cold, Dad. I was like, hey, man.
Hey, that's life.
Yeah. How's Lou doing?
He's better.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, he's got to get it together.
How's your daughter?
She's great. She's calling me now.
Oh, y'all talking again?
Yeah, we're back to talking. Yeah. She's like, I miss you, Dad. Love you. You know.
I still like pussy, send money. Have a great day.
Oh, really? Did you really say that?
Yeah, she's a feminist.
Hey, come on. So she's good. Lou's just got to get it together.
How's Sydney doing?
Oh, yeah. There's a ribbon in the sky for our love.
You know who I saw?
Cindy Lewis on keys.
No, I didn't see Julius. She came to the taping of the show. Shalia.
Oh.
Yeah, she walked up. Don't you know who I am? I was like, no.
No.
Women kill me with that. I mean, it's been like 20, 50 some years. No, she just didn't look the same. She'd been through menopause and all that stuff.
Yeah.
Damn. She's still married. And she asked about you.
Wow.
You know, yeah, Shalia. That was, that was funny. I was like, I thought of you. I was like, wow, Geoff, Shalia.
She came to the Bob Hart's tape.
Yeah. Yeah, that was
Your girl, Lou.
Who?
Who?
Shalia. Mm. Shalia was cool. She babysat the kids and all that. She said she still keeps in contact with the kid's mom and all that.
That's what you refer to as the kid's mom?
Yeah, I've cut that off.
Oh, wow. You've had to? Oh, since you moved back in.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
You can't take her calls at 1 o'clock.
I didn't move back in, but I, you know, I cut that cord.
Oh, okay.
That cord is gone.
Cut that cord. You ain't jamming.
Cut that cord. Cut that cord. All right, hut four. Or hut.
That was Tita Sports Ticker.
All right, that's cool.
You have your topic, Jeff.
That's right here. Topic right
Hold
here.
On.
Topic two.
Yeah, it's on the paper. What you talking about? Get it together.
Now,
Comedian Beats.
I want to, but can we, before we do this topic, can we?
We have a call. Hold up.
I had a Black History fact.
So
is it really a Black History fact?
Yeah. So
Speedy sent me his picture of his son.
Another man. Highlight.
Yeah. Missed the layup.
Can his son ball?
Nope.
Nope. Can Speedy ball?
Nope.
Nope.
This woman right here. Florence Price.
Oh, okay.
Florence Price.
Name.
There she is, Florence Price. This is my Black History.
April 9th is her birthday.
I was listening to classical music, which I do, and she was, and they talked about her. And she was an American classical composer.
Yeah.
And, you know, pianist and organist, music
you
teacher.
You like pianist?
She was born in Little Rock, Arkansas.
Little Rock.
She was educated. Now, here's the thing. She was born 1887 and died 1953.
Yeah.
1887.
Yeah.
That this woman could
that was a good year.
Be do what she did, accomplish what she accomplished, to be so. I mean, she died. She was in Chicago. She was active in Chicago from 1927 until her death in 1953.
Now, do you know a company opened up in 1880?
She composed over 300 works, 87? Four symphonies, four concertos rather, as well as
concertos.
Thank you. And art songs, chamber music.
Don't go to opera.
No.
I mean, she
no
was.
No culture.
But it made me think about how incredible this woman was.
No, she still is incredible.
Do you know what she had to go through and fight through?
Well,
she still was able to educate herself. And we come from her. Yeah. Megan Stallion.
No, you can't do that.
Yeah. Okay, I was going to ask you that. So where do I put that? Help me with that then.
You put that to where she was in her time and place. 1887, she was born. I think Martinelli's Apple Juice, that company, was around at that time.
And who's to say that she wasn't twerking back then?
Right. Just a different time.
So that's why I'm not being judgmental. I'm asking.
She could have been a can dancer. She could have been all that until she got to, you know, get where she was going.
Okay.
It's a different time piece.
All right. And I accept that. I'm trying to get better with
that. That's the Victorian age.
Yeah, I'm trying to get better at that. But shout out to Florence Price. And all the young girls who decided that they want to do classical music. I love classical
music.
So
maybe she could teach Sydney something.
Who? Sydney's taking classes with her.
There's a cripple in the sky for our love.
Wow.
Cindy Lewis on keys. No, we got a call.
Let's call it.
Caller, you're on the air.
She's going to do her solo.
Yo.
Hey,
what's up, Dad?
Turn your house down, nigga.
Thanks for the shout out.
You're welcome, sir. You're welcome.
And good to see you back, Jeff. Good to see you back, Jeff.
Okay.
Well, thank you, sir.
That's not what he said. He told me.
Yeah, whatever. No, don't try to muddy the waters.
He tried to tell me, he's like, man, you did a good thing by getting rid of him.
Yeah, he said
when
that.
Because when he come to LA, he know who to hook up with.
Yeah.
You guys got history. We've been hanging out a long time.
Yeah, we've been taking Viagra a long time.
I'll make sure there ain't no fentanyl in the coke.
Hey, how you feeling?
You still got my lighter?
Yeah, I still got it.
Does it still work?
No, it don't. Never didn't work when you gave it to me.
Never didn't work when you? Okay, who learned you how to smoke? You got a lot of water in your body, huh?
How you feeling?
Yeah, how you feeling?
Not with both his hands.
Mr. Dix?
Now you what? What are you, 80? What are you, 80?
83.
Damn!
83.
I'm trying to get there.
83.
I'm trying to get there.
Yeah, played around the golf yesterday.
Oh, okay.
We're going to have your next birthday at the cemetery.
I know. I make sure I don't drive close to it.
All right, I'm glad you're feeling better, and I love you. Take care, man.
All right, later. Later.
Yeah, whatever.
Now, that's interesting, because
Sydney gonna be like, hey, granddad.
It's interesting.
Well, can I sit on your lap?
You know, you hear people say, my father's never said, I love you.
Yeah.
Whatever. Like, I say, I love you. Mm-hmm. And he very seldom says it back.
He doesn't really? Need to.
You don't feel the love from him?
No, I know he loves me. But then it's interesting because I say that to my kids all the time. I'm not complaining.
You are.
No, I'm just saying. Are you hurt? Say that you hear that generation. Your dad?
Yeah.
But you know what? Some people.
Is he? You don't look like none of your sisters.
I was going to say, some people are deeply affected by that.
What do you mean?
When their parents don't tell them that they love them.
Yeah.
I think it's a generational thing.
What they say you love?
That they just, men of his generation.
Yeah.
Just, that's just not that's something that they say.
Because my dad didn't really start saying it till later in life.
Yeah.
He wasn't very, like, affectionate.
Mm-hmm.
And, but he didn't start saying it till later.
Yeah. Now, when's the last time your dad said, I'm sorry.
Oh, come on. Why are we doing this?
Now, do you say, did you love him?
No, he used to say, like, man, get the fuck out of my face. Go to the store. Keep the change. Oh, I was like, oh, dad.
Did he say he loved you?
All the time.
That was his way. He said he loved you.
Yeah.
Keep the change.
Take this 20. Oh, nigga, you too little. Get robbed.
Now, did your dad say he loved
all the time.
So he verbalized?
All the time, yeah. To me and my two brothers, all the time. All
right, that's interesting.
I think he loved me more, though.
Okay. Oh, you think he loves it? Now, Dannon, I'm assuming.
Well, it's tough. That's a tough crowd.
He didn't hear that. I assume he.
Yeah, that's a tough crowd.
I mean,
thanks, Foster Claus.
I'm sorry. But yeah, I've always wanted to say, hey, man, why don't you say that? But I don't.
To your dad?
Yeah.
Why? You should have said it now.
No, I just.
Too scared.
No, I just.
You remember that ass whooping playing football in the street?
Did he say it to Mike?
I don't know.
Well, maybe he's listening and.
He don't care. He got water in his body.
No, I mean, I know he loves
brother?
Me. Huh?
Do you say it to your brother?
My brother Michael?
Yeah.
I don't
yeah.
talk to him enough.
Why?
But I do say I love him.
Okay.
I don't talk to him
Y'all
enough.
Took baths together?
He splashed water.
Remember that time? What?
You splashed water on my pee-pee.
Remember that time I wore that cowboy jersey in the tub?
We actually never took a bath together. We didn't do that.
Do you say it to your sisters?
I think so. I don't know. A queen. All right. Here's our queen. Beauty of the week. Jet beauty of the week.
Oh,
ah,
wow.
Southern comfort. She's got big hands.
Yeah.
That she does.
No, you just got a little weenie. That's all.
She's okay. Not big.
Move hands. Your thumb.
She has long. Her hands are long.
That isn't my thumb.
Look at her.
I can't see it.
Look at her wrist.
I think the photo might
Thank
be
you,
a little bottom, out of proportion.
Yeah. Okay. That's not in high def.
Read the
she looking at you right
now. It's on the outline.
On the paper, oh, okay. You idiot.
He can't read. You need to put your glasses on.
All right, she's Southern Comfort. Lovely Caroline Beauty of Louisville.
Oh, wow. You
was
Carolyn Betty.
No, it says, oh, yeah, Betty. I'm sorry.
Damn.
Of Louisville was a senior counseling major. She's major at University of Louisville, where she was also Miss Black University of University of Louisville.
Ville whore!
1973. Wow. Now, that hair is real, right, Poetess?
Louisville. Yeah, that's 73, boy.
Okay.
It was all natural.
All natural.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, it looks like she put it in sponge rollers.
She
got her hands on her hip like, nigga, what you want?
You see a little Felicia Rashad?
She has these beautiful eyes, though.
Yeah.
Does she remind you of Alicia?
No.
Nah. Okay.
No. Is that just Steve's back in the day, Lou?
That would have been my. That would have been my. Wow. Yeah, that would have been my go-to. Yo, man, she was. Yeah, she. But
get away
but
from me, Creed.
But now knowing what I know,
with her hands on the hips like that.
Well, you know what to play. Now you know what to play. So
yeah.
Oh, you do stand-up comedy? Oh, okay.
A word from our sponsor.
Did you see this?
Oh.
We played this. This thing was the funniest thing.
No. With Dannon?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You didn't see this
ugly
thing?
Bitch or something? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, let me God. Pull it out.
You didn't know?
She's just late.
Why are you here?
She's just late.
So late, Lou.
I didn't load it up because Dannon's
well, that's
not
what she said.
Same thing she said.
Now, but now it's what the beauty's. I mean, Code right? 3 is just as beautiful.
Oh, she is. She is.
Now, you're just saying that because you moved back in?
I did not move back in, but she is beautiful.
Okay.
She's beautiful inside, outside.
Oh, especially on the inside.
Oh, man, well, you just chilling.
Oh, my bad. All right. I got excited.
Yeah, do you say that?
She's tough. She's a cop.
Rugged and raw.
She's tough. She's a cop. She's got all the qualities.
And she's a great cleaner.
Yeah.
Yeah, she can clean up.
She'll clean the kitchen.
She cook?
Yeah, yeah, no, our season is weak.
Bitch, you is ugly.
All right, now go back.
Wait a minute. How do you have a good day after that? Where do you go? To Sonic? Where do you go?
Sonic.
Get your courage back.
Is that enough to make you hate?
Yeah, that's making me have to shoot a bitch.
That's enough to make you got to get out the car.
Man, I'll buck at her.
You know, you got to get out the car at that point.
Call me
ugly.
No,
he knows he ugly. It's not a shot.
He had a feeling, but he didn't really know for sure. Yeah. She just validated it. Let me go out here and see if I'm ugly.
He said, well, damn.
Well, damn.
Like, he woke up in the morning, brushed
his teeth, put a little Vaseline on his head, thought he was looking good.
She made it official.
Yeah. So, okay, now, last time, Geoff had sent some videos in when he was
here. And you didn't want to play them.
Yeah.
You were boycotting.
Yeah. I was fired.
Yeah.
No, you wasn't.
You went there.
No, I didn't. You did. I did not. So, and then what was this thing about you smoking whatever you said?
Freebase.
That's what my dad says. He said he didn't smoke crack.
Freebase.
It's a difference.
You freebase.
Yeah.
You did?
Yes.
Yeah.
I didn't do crack. It's for niggas.
Yeah, he loved it. Oh, bougie Negro. The bourgeoisie, nigga.
I smoke freebase in a suit.
Ooh.
In a suit?
Yes. Yeah.
Burn my twice.
In Chicago? Tights.
Yes. I knew how to cook it and all that. Yes. Yes.
You were slinging it?
Yes.
No, I'm the dope man.
Look at that. That is hilarious.
I'm the dope man. You have nice shoulders.
I was selling it. I did that.
Beat me up, Scotty. I control your body.
Cedar is on fire.
Yeah, I sold it, and then I, you know.
Yeah, in hell.
And how did you come out of it?
I'm here.
That part.
So did you quit on your own?
Yes. I went. Yes.
Yeah. My dad quit cold, too.
Yeah. And I'm starting to now tell that story on stage now.
Okay.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Good.
What is it like? Yes. How does it go?
It's going good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, how do you just go into it?
No, I just said, you know, been clean and sober for 36 years.
Your probation officer, yeah, hold on.
You know, I used to freebase, you know, and
then what's the show? You say that, and what do they do?
Whoa. Yeah, it's like, wow. But then a couple of people, like, oh, okay.
Can I give you a tag for that?
Yes.
When you say, I used to freebase, but let me tell you how expensive it was.
Yeah.
Ah.
There you go. Yeah. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Okay, is that a caller?
Caller! You're on the air!
Yo, what's up, TDP?
Hey, how you feeling there?
Beautiful, beautiful. Hey, I was wondering, Geoff.
Yes, sir.
When can I catch you at a show that's outside of L.A.?
Okay.
When I'm outside of L.A.?
Mm-hmm. That's your job. Ask who it is.
Who is this?
This is Noel from Northern Cali.
Oh, hey, what's up, Noel?
Noel.
Yes, sir. I'm trying to be an Apollo legend, but I want to start off slow.
Oh. Yeah, you're doing a horrible job.
Yes.
Hey, how long have you been listening? How long have you been listening to the show? That's funny. Could you take Jeff's picture off that thing,
please? You ever seen me smoke?
She trying to make you have a flashback?
That ether going through my body.
Yeah. Yeah.
Noel.
Nah.
How long have you been listening to the show?
I want to say 2015, 2014.
Oh, wow.
Okay,
sorry
nice.
To hear that. Are you from you from the Bay Area?
Yes, sir.
Sorry to hear that.
Yeah. Okay, so hey, my kid's mom moving back up there. Get with her.
Is she?
Yes.
No.
No, you have, I'm sorry, you married?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
I'm trying to find one of them, not Soul Train Beauties, but one of them.
Jet Beauty?
Jet Magazine Beauties, but in Atlanta.
Oh, okay. Got to go to the retirement home.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So good. Your question is,
Buckhead.
So I'm trying to see where I can find Geoff performing outside of L.A.
What am I outside
of
L.A.?
I've never seen any shows being broadcasted or even mentioned about Geoff outside of L.A. and even in Chicago.
Mm.
I'll go there. Because I really want to see what his stand-up looks like, but I'm not coming to L.A.
You'd be amazed. You'd be a fan. Trust me.
All right, so next time.
No, I'm already a fan.
Okay, lose the attitude.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah.
So now, okay.
When I do it, we're going to stay in touch. So when I do a show, when I come to the Bay Area, I'm definitely going to invite you.
Yeah.
So, and
oh,
if I,
my God.
Or send me or
Noel. Here's the thing.
We have a Facebook page.
Yeah, we can go ahead and when he's doing the show out here, we'll get you down. I was gonna say fly, but we'll get you on the train. No, we'll fly you down.
Trail away.
We'll fly you down. You have any friends?
No.
Damn. Right. Why are you living?
I was gonna say you can drive down.
I'm playing. I'm a traveler, so I just again, this is just LA is not my place, but
I do have a couple of links. Just leave your email. If you have an email, leave it with Poetess, and then I'll send you a link.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so okay. Do that. I'm a little. So you don't want to know when Dan is performing or myself?
Let's go.
I know where I can find. Wow. Peter, I might come to LA for. I might come to LA for.
I'm not single.
Good, good. That way, you ain't got no. I ain't got nothing to worry about there.
That far.
So yeah, that. So far, yeah. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to see you two. I know where I could see Lewis Dix.
Yeah.
Because he's all over the place.
Yeah.
Just sporadic.
Well, yeah. Sporadically. He threw that in. Yeah, sporadically. That hurt my elbow, man. Come on, Noel. Hey, well, we really appreciate you taking the time to
Absolutely,
listen, man.
Absolutely, Noel.
Thank you so much. And go ahead and donate.
And make sure you send your email with Poetess.
Yeah.
Well, you can just give it to us now. What's your email?
Oh, you don't want everybody to have
I can't
it.
Do it over the air, okay. Man.
Well, it's only 16 people.
Box. You ain't popular.
All right, so you give it to... So hang on and Poetess will get it from you, okay?
Okay, sounds good.
All right, hold bro. The line. Thanks, man. This is our first hold the line, okay?
Hilarious.
We're getting better.
So, I'm working on the joke, and it's, you know, I'm being honest with you.
Yeah,
so.
Put that right there and then take off.
And then I tell them, you know, that I was at the McCormick Inn, the amphitheater in Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
And just build it up. And then I was like, my homie, he threw me a party afterwards because I did such a great job.
Well, we weren't there.
Yeah. And I opened up for Frankie Beverly and Maze.
Okay. Oh, it's a hot show.
Yeah, so I did a good job. So I went in the bathroom, and he sent three women in there.
Mm.
And then he was like, yo, this is for you.
Okay.
And then I was freebasing with them, and then they pulled my pants down.
Okay.
And my weenie was like a little thumb, a thimble. And that's enough to make you. And it was interesting because the girl got on her knees.
That's going to put my eye out.
Yeah, and the girl got on her knees, and she was just like, look, he got a little baby dick.
Aw. Welcome to Chicago.
That's graphic, man.
Yeah, but that's what I tell them on stage, you know. And people who have experienced that, one guy when I was in Arizona when I did it, he was rolling,
mm-hmm.
and he like went to the stage, and he was like, and I dapped him up, and I said, you've been a man, I know
exactly
what you're talking about. So you also got to add, you know, we love adding jokes, mm-hmm. parts. You should say,
I want to take yours. I like
okay. now that I've been seen clean so for 30 years, my wee-wee is grown.
Okay, we're going to move on. Okay. Thanks for that pitch. See, that's what happened in pitch me.
Yeah, exactly.
Pull!
So I tell that. That's the premise of it. So,
that's funny. That's honest. That's real.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just
that's the thing. And that was with comics. I saw comedy. I've been like going to clubs and all that. And why are we so fixated on? One thing I want to say is that with Los Angeles being the mecca of comedy,
mm-hmm.
as a comedian here, you're not allowed to grow here.
Yeah. No, you can grow, but they just want to see an instant.
Yeah, because I see comics doing the same shit over and over and over and over and over and over and over again. And I mean, because I don't think comedians are afraid to bomb in front of an audience. I think it's more like they're afraid to bomb in front of their peers. Because
that's all it's going to be is your peers.
No, but I mean, yeah, some shows, you know, if like when comics come out here, and they all stop at the Dime. And mm-hmm. they're like, oh, this is the OG of comedy. It's like, you know, it's come up, I'm seeing you, and it's like, okay. And I always tell them, mm-hmm. well, you don't want to perform at first.
Mm. Right.
Because if you go to Mondays at the Improv or Chocolate Sundays, there's no second chance for first impressions.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Because if you bomb in front of a bunch of comedians, you know, basically you dog shit.
Your mold is casted.
Yeah, they're gonna be like, oh, that. But
we're all from the generation where you had to do new stuff and you were challenged. Yes. You challenged right. yourself, and Definitely. Everybody appreciated.
Right.
They would actually come up and say, "I like that new one you did."
Right.
And now they don't. So all right. So
wait a minute. I want to say that because back when DL was hosting the Birdland West
mm-hmm.
in Long Beach, and he had a joke where
was so high that he poured out a whole bag of weed because he looked at his rearview mirror and it was a goddamn Volvo with ski racks on it. Yeah. Thought it was the police.
Yeah. You don't take them goddamn ski racks off.
Yep. That's funny. That's funny.
Huh. And now, let me ask you this question, because this is a day now. Would you do a TikTok video?
Like now?
Yeah.
I mean, I've sat and wanted to do a cover of a song, you know, like a video.
You can't sing. Your mama told
you
that.
I know, but I want to do a video of, like, certain songs I hear.
Yeah.
I want to do a video of it, like Jay-Z's song.
No, that ain't you. You more of a fame soundtrack. Pick a song off of there and do it. Because you know that song. You know we're feeling an emotion, and people want to see that.
You remember the conversation we had where they doing, like the biggest beef going on now is the internet comics that do TikTok videos and all of that. And I had a conversation with you before, back in the 90s, when Video Jukebox came out.
Mm.
And I was like, yo, this is what comedians should do.
Yeah.
We should go ahead and visualize our jokes.
Right.
We should do that. And you was like, nah, don't do that. And then I met with Doug Williams, and he is just like, that's the stupidest idea I ever fucking heard of.
And wow. Now it's blown up.
And it's blown up. Like, Desi Banks is doing it. He kind of reconfigured your McDonald's joke, but he was working at Wendy's.
Yeah.
And I'm watching and I'm like, okay, Lewis did that joke.
Yeah.
He just changed a little bit around, but yeah.
Oh, wow.
I was surprised.
Who asked?
I was surprised he sold out L.A.
Who?
Desi Banks.
He has a following.
Yeah. Yes. I know that now.
Who is Desi Banks?
He's a comedian, man. And Mike Epps.
Parlay!
And Mike Epps is, what he's doing now is like, when I look at Mike Epps, he's not fucking with older comics.
Mm-hmm.
He's surrounding himself with the young comics.
As he should.
Yeah. The TikTok, the Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like
the internet.
Said, like I watched the Breakfast Club interview with Drewski.
Mm-hmm.
And like Charlamagne asked him, and I like Drewski.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's a funny motherfucker. Like Charlamagne was like, well, now our networks approaching you about a sitcom because you need your own TV sitcom.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, yeah, but I don't need the networks now.
Right.
He said, because if I do a TV network, a sitcom, maybe 3 to 5 million will watch. I'll do a 5-minute video, and I can get 80 million people watching.
Right.
So that's
I've never seen. Who is this guy?
Drewski. Yeah, he's funny.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so out of touch.
Yeah.
I'm dealing with muddy
like
waters.
Like network TV, it's an old dinosaur model. So, you know, it's a different grind than being on social media.
You got to watch it now because within the next 3 to 4 or 5 years, it's not going to be cable.
Mm-hmm.
There's not going to be no more cable because everything is going here. So your big screens and all of that,
yeah,
it's going to be gone. Because listen to what Roger Goodell said. He said, we got to fish
NFL commissioner
where there's fish in the water at. So when they did that experiment on that Sunday Night Football and they had
Peacock.
Peacock. It was the Kansas City Chiefs. You paid $5.99, 53 million people paid that to watch it.
Yeah.
So this is right here is you can get everything now.
It's the new optical.
Right in the phone, yeah.
Yeah. People in their cars driving watching TV.
Yeah, you're right, because I used to fight it.
Mm-hmm.
But now I'll pop up and watch something on my phone.
Absolutely.
And I've been watching these police videos, the auditors.
Yeah.
Oh, the First Amendment?
Yeah, First Amendment auditors. Wear me up. They crack me up.
Is that a felony or a misdemeanor?
Yeah. Is that feelings is not a crime.
Yeah. That's the way they talk to them.
I mean, it goes well for, because now they got Hispanic dude doing it, the Hispanic dude. The cops act totally different to the other, the white dudes.
The white dude, Amagasin Press?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know.
Yeah,
but it teaches you a lot, though.
And the female cops are hilarious.
Yeah.
Because they, you know, oh, no, you're going to show me ID.
Yeah.
Are you going to show me ID?
I don't have to show you anything.
Yeah.
Tell
me what crime I committed.
Yeah.
Tell me what crime I committed.
And when they can't tell you that, because I mean.
Okay, have a nice day, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, they get
upset. I'm doing my job here. You're making it very difficult. You want to play these games? That's a favorite line.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Let's do that. Okay, I'm Lewis Dix.
TDP.
Geoff Arnold.
Of course, we want to thank Poo Lee, Mr. C,
Mr.
my dad.
C.
I love you. Noel Seymour, I apologize. Geoff Brown.
Seymour, GB.
And for taking the time to listen.
It's
sure
Jeff with a G, not a J.
I know, but I wrote it with a J.
That's lazy.
Hey, you know, just what
lazy.
You
lazy.
Dannon, next
Don't
time.
Don't come, I mean, get well.
Yeah. Whatever's wrong with you, it was.
May it stay on you.
No, feel better. I'm glad you're back. Welcome back, homie.
Before we go, I wanted to play this video that Tommy Davidson done that I saw today. That was hilarious to me. So okay. Here it goes. Uh-oh.
You're never ready.
Siento pamparitos y la río, el tío, el río, el río. Es como un cinto para que me juntan carando el cinto un tal rico. Bueno, burro que me siento un cuán bueno por rico. Es a manzana, grito en banca, le está teniendo y grito. Jalín grande y rondo, era con Tereso, 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 Tereso.
Yeah, that's a part of his comedy bit.
Yeah, because he does a bit where it's funnier when he's just doing the bit.
Yeah.
I don't think that does justice to the bit.
Yeah, that guy, other guy, I think he's a comedian too.
That looked like...
Now that's for
that looked
TikTok
like,
and social media. That's what that's for.
It's funny, so but I bet you Tom Davis looked like his daddy.
When you lied on your resume but still got the job.
That looks like D-Lay. That's who that looked like.
Okay. Good eyes.
Look. He's doing a lot of videos.
Who, D-Lay?
Yeah.
That looked like D-Lay.
I think his name is Call Me Choco.
Who, the guy?
The other guy.
Oh, maybe that's not D-Lay. Yeah, I mean,
he does a lot of
D-Lay is hilarious.
Yeah.
He's funny. Okay, so.
Absolutely.
Thank you for that, boss lady.
Thank you for that bullshit.
Yeah. We'll see you. Next week.
Will we?
Well, let's see.
It ain't a holiday or nothing?
No. We'll see you next week. I know there's a... Yeah, we'll see you next week.
So you guys have another game to play?
Yeah, we play Saturday, and then we'll play...
Up north?
Tuesday. No, we go up north next Saturday if we win the two games.
Y'all playing at the Staples Center?
No, it'd be funny.
Y'all go back up to...
We play at home. Our next two games are at home.
Oh, that's a waste of time.
Yeah, next two games are home. Then up in Sacramento, wherever the Kings play.
Arco Arena?
They refurbished that yet? No, it's a new arena.
Yeah. So we'll
I went to the old Arco. I know that one.
Yeah, we'll be back on the 7th.
Cowbells.
March 7th, we'll be back. And then
Oak Park.
That's next week.
Yeah, next week. Yeah, we'll be back next week.
Florin Road.
Yeah.
Sacktown.
If I'm not fired.
Oh, hilarious.
Yeah.
You would never. I never said he was fired.
You did.
No, I didn't.
You did.
I felt
you said it on the phone.
Yeah, I said it to you. I said it to Poetess.
Okay.
And then I kept feeling bad. Like, you think he's going to come back?
Thank you, Seymour.
Thanks, Seymour. Thank you. Thank you for everybody that contributed. Thank
you. Jackie.
Jackie.
Sorry, I didn't write the list down. I'll shout out.
Yeah, you've been off today. What's going on?
She had that.
Man, I've had a very busy week.
Talk to her.
She was just happy that I was here.
You met with Karen Bass?
No, I met with Big Boy.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
And I put in a bid to do 12 podcast episodes for L.A. County. So hopefully that goes through. But I had to do a... put in a bid, so it's like you write this whole presentation and took me a few
Can I do the voiceover?
No, I just been grinding, that's all.
As you should. All right, we're out.
All right, see y'all next week.
Fuck peace.